and teaching, and information age teaching. Okay, that is what was say if industry age, if you are defining some last 100 years or 120 years, you define as industrial age, where the schools got formed and all that. You have quite a old schools in terms of Oxford and all that, but it was a kind of elitist in approach. Okay, the education available to common masses, we can track it back to some 100 or 120 odd years. Okay, so you would be surprised to know that this organized form of education came in Iran. Okay, today it is known for some other reasons, but if you look at Iran, that's where the Shah there or whoever the ruler was, he thought it is absolutely essential for every person to be educated. It is as simple as that. So there should be a formal education system. So that's how the thing started flowing. Okay, so industrial age in fact accelerated the whole process. So in India we had the Varna system. Okay, so the whole community was divided into different caste groups and all that, and each one was focusing on what they were doing. Okay, and they were acquiring the knowledge accordingly. So if an agriculturist there, he is a kind of a son of the soil. He knows what all characteristics that is possible with the soil. Okay, so however a great eminent scientists are, okay, in terms of, because my dad comes from the as a principal scientist in agriculture field. Okay, they were one of the pioneers in the green revolution that happened in India. So still, when I talk to a farmer, other day I was talking to a farmer a week back, last Sunday I suppose, yeah. So the kind of insights they have, however knowledgeable and so-called PhD holders or brilliant, whatever it is, okay, he was, to the core, they were able to come out with certain insights that kind of really fascinated me. Okay, so now coming back to the first question would be, what is the difference between an industrial age teaching to information age teaching? The what we are now in this last one or two decades, we are into information age. Okay, as a teacher, what is the fundamental difference? Anyone? It's open session, so anyone can just unmute and come out with your ideas, please. Hello. Abhishek, you can have a go because alphabetical order. Abhishek, yeah. Are you there? Okay, one wicket down. What about Arun? Hello. Yeah, are you able to hear me? Hello.
Yes, sir, we can.
Yes, sir. So where is Abhishek? Sir. Okay. Yes, muted and he is there somewhere. Okay.
He's put up something on the chat. Internet bandwidth issues.
Internet bandwidth issues. Okay, fine, great. What about Arun? Arun. So what issue he is having?
He's there.
Ma'am, sir, one second, sir. Actually, I'm speaking to one of the students' parent here.
Ah.
Just one second, sir. I'll come back.
So that's how the webinars are getting conducted. Okay, cool. Okay.
So can I go? As in, can I put
Yes. I kept it as an open house. Anybody can.
Yeah. Sorry. I think like what I feel is industrial age teaching was more of, you know, textbook or something which was more like, you know, what we call it in today's term, we call it traditional. Why? Because our teachers knew certain things and they want whatever they learned, they you know, gave it to us in terms of textbooks or in terms of story knowledge, storytelling, and however they have given it that way. Now in the, when we come to the information age, there is information not only from our teachers, but from all over the world. So like, you know, today in the morning, I just had a thought that, you know, I wanted to cook momos. Okay. Sorry. I'm just since it's just an open session. And I, the first thing that came to my mind, okay, I'll just search on YouTube. I didn't have to remember, you know, earlier, if we have to cook something, our grandmothers had that special, or our, you know, grandparents had that special thing where they had to remember where and what and how. Here, there's nothing like, remember, we have a ready reference, go check it out, do it. You don't have to put it in your, you know, RAM, as in your brain and all that. So okay. I think in the information age, information is so much easily available from everywhere of the world that it's become very easier to learn than what it was in the earlier days.
Okay, fine. Anybody else?
Sir, even though it is nowadays the information is available on various sources, students, they can get a lot of information over the, like, you know, for all digital platform, wherever it may be. But students, they can gain the knowledge on online, sir. But they are, when they will interact with the teachers in classroom atmosphere only, they will gain the skills, sir. Skills are experienced through in the physical mode of with teachers only, sir, what I feel.
Okay.
So fine. Every teachers, they have to develop their own uniqueness of, like, no. So now, like, students, they got a lot of information. We have to step one step forward. What we are going to teach beyond that, how we are going to, like, you know, give the information to the students, that's matter, sir, nowadays.
Okay. Anybody else?
Sir, actually, I have one input with the online class.
Mm-hmm.
That is... yes, the information is available to the student 24/7. Even after the session is completed, they can actually look at the recordings and, you know, they can enhance, they can understand much more better. But, you know, I could see a certain change in the way the you know, the student's involvement is there in the classes. That is, you know, their level of you know, being attentive in the class as well as doing the assignment of time on time has actually reduced a little bit.
Yes.
They are taking much more longer time in you know, submitting the assignment.
They are used to danda culture of close room circle, okay, where they were forced to do certain activities.
Yes.
Okay. Now that they have been given some choice, okay,
yes,
a distraction. And,
yeah.
Okay.
And one more point is, like, you know, in the recent times, the YouTube actually has become a number one source for all the contents which is there, including for teachers as well as for students. But I could see a trend in the popular channels which were there in the YouTube for past 10 years, which was actually teaching Unity, Maya, and all the softwares. They are actually leaving the channel and going to some other thing, some other business. So those were, like, you know, top people who are actually tutoring us on Blender, Maya, and all. They are actually leaving that channel and, you know, going to some other pasture. So I saw, like, around 10 channels actually, they are saying bye bye to YouTube and, you know, they are starting their own business. So that trend is also happening.
Okay. Yes. Fine. So thank you. Do you think, like, doctors, architects, lawyers, okay, our educators are also a professional service? Yes or no?
Definitely yes.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Definitely yes, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
When a doctor, when you go to, when you have a problem, when you go to doctor, the interaction is 1:1, right or wrong?
Mm.
When you want to build a house, you want to meet the architect, okay, to design a home, okay? It is again a 1:1 interaction, right or wrong?
Mm.
Okay, when you want to independently build a house, not buy a flat or something like that, okay? When you want to sit and design your own home with an architect. Mm. It is a 1:1 exercise. And when you have a problem and you want to legally fight it out, okay, you go to a lawyer, right? Okay. Lawyer, again, he gives the 1:1 services.
Mm.
As a professional, okay, educator, he's a professional, right? And he's giving services to 1:25. That is the norms that is being laid out. Do you see the fundamental discrepancy here?
Mm.
Okay. Fundamental discrepancy is each one has his own learning curve. Like, every student has his own learning curve. Okay. Each one learns in a certain way. Okay. Which is unique to that individual. And here we are using a batch processing, industrial age. Industrial age mein kya hota hai? The supply line, the whatever, the production line. Okay. The same set of instruction goes and the product is getting manufactured. And we say this is the passing metric in terms of quality. Okay, whoever passes that quality, passed. Okay, whoever fails in the quality, fails. What happened to the failures? We are not bothered. We give a kind of batch processing information. Okay, and we conduct assessment. And those who pass, they pass. Those who fail, they fail. You understand? So the problem here is, yes, if you are running something, a competency, something like some accounts or something you want to teach, okay, where the rules and laws don't change much, or the same set of construct gets followed for 20, 30 years, okay, this batch processing is very good. Yeah, you learn this set of things. This is how it has to be learned. This is how it has to be delivered. Okay. So earlier, if somebody does a BCom or something like that, and he learns some how to do the accounts, okay, that will hold him good for next 20, 30 years. He will be the clerk, or he will be whatever the financial consultant or whatever he, so not financial consultant, whatever he's supposed to deliver in terms of processing the financial information. There is a certain way, there's a certain construct. Clear? Okay. But today, if you look at, those things have got automated. You don't require a manual intervention there, be it a railway ticketing system or, for that matter, a banking services. I hardly see my bank in the last 6 years. I would have gone some 4 times to the bank. Okay, I do not even know where the, if the branch gets relocated, I don't even know where it is. Okay, I don't require to know where it is. Okay, that is the kind of automation that is seeping in, where any predictable processes will get automated. So what is the role of humans? And that is where the big question mark comes. How do we skill them? Okay. Now, when we say the difference between what you call it as skilling, okay, versus say some concepts you are learning, how would you put it? Because if you are pursuing from other verticals, most of the time you are understanding some logics, some concepts, okay, be it in programming or be it in finance or in marketing. So there are certain constructs, right or wrong, okay, that you don't really require any intervention. It has to be taught in a very cohesive, logical manner, right or wrong, okay. With that, it's done, okay, compared to a skill, okay. When you say skill, painting is a skill, okay, riding bicycle is a skill, okay, because you should know the fine art of balancing, right or wrong, okay. Now, how do you basically segregate from a educator perspective the difference between teaching a concept and vis-a-vis with teaching a skill? So when you teach a skill, it has to be very fluidic and automatic. When I say fluidic and automatic, when you are changing your gears in a, say in a car, or when you are changing gears in a bike, it goes very automatically. Okay, very fluidic in nature. You will not say, now, yeah, now there is a stop sign. I will go for, I press the brake. I will come back to neutral, or I will come back to first gear. You don't do that. You automatically, fluidically it goes. So when an artist sketches, okay, the kinesthetic part of it goes very fluidically. Okay, whatever he sees, that wonderful world, he is able to transcribe it, or he is able to get inspired from that world and create his own designs. Okay, now the whole problem comes again to the construct of a professional. So there is a great need of 1:1 involvement, not 1:25 involvement, because not all the 25 people learn in the same way, okay, or gather their skills in a certain way. Are we clear about this? So whatever, but generally people who administer today are from the industrial age outlook. Typically they would be 60, 65 or plus 50 or plus 55, who have worked in a certain way for last 20, 30, 2, 3 decades or 4 decades more. They would have contributed to whatever might their this thing in a certain way. Okay, certain way they had their thought process shaped up. Now, it becomes all the more challenging to convince them, because over 35 universities, when we interact and try to convince the various vice chancellors, okay, more than anything, I would be worried about how I would fit in their template, whatever template they have drawn for themselves, okay, or as a vision for the concerned university, how do I adapt to that requirement? Are we clear? That's where I go to the first question. Okay. So can we, as a professional, administer the same way the other courses are other programs are administered. So if we have to have a variance, how do we do that? Because we are a small minority. So other day, I think Dr. Nachappa was going through some statistics about universities and all that. Okay, so we have 900 universities, 52,000 colleges, blah, 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 blah. It went on and on and on, 8 crore people pursuing and all that. So how many universities do have a department in media, especially in animation, visual effects, gaming, or filmmaking? Any idea?
Only one Central Institute of Technology in Pojahar, Assam only. And second in IIT Bombay, IIT Guwahati, IIT Delhi also, and recently IIT Hyderabad is also starting. Our BDS in specialization with communication design, and that they are teaching animation also.
Okay. So if you look at ours, what is the population of India?
Every day it's rising.
Every day it is rising. Every second it is rising. Okay. 10 births, 7 deaths, something like that. Okay. So as we say, okay, roughly we can take a figure of 136 crores. Okay, with some 800 million people watching audiovisual content at a given point of time. Okay, I'm interacting with you. It is happening through some audiovisual process in a digitized format. Okay, same way, because of the COVID, most of the interaction is happening digitally. Okay, even otherwise, if you look at it, we have a lot of distraction in terms of the social media. WhatsApp or Facebook, it's people keep going on and on on this. Okay, most of the time it is only audiovisual. Okay, either they are about their own selfies or about some video or some sharing some joke or something like that. But most of the time it is audiovisual content that gets a lot of traction. Now comes our issue: how well we are adapted to this new requirement. When I say adapted. Okay, because these platforms were not there, be it OTT. Okay, if you take OTT platform, okay, that was not there a decade back, right or wrong? Okay, today, how many of you have watched a web series? Every one of you would have watched some web series, right or wrong? You might have Amazon for free, or for that matter, Netflix, or you name it, Hotstar, or any of this. These were not available then. Okay, it is available to today. Okay. So when we talk about the content, a content was put up in a particular way in a television series, okay, where, okay, coming back to again, what is the difference between a television series versus a web series? Any idea? It's open, just unmute and you talk. What is the difference between a television serial, okay, series?
So television series, we have to go with some government compliance, but in web series, there is no any regulatory body from anything we can display over there.
Okay, that is sure. So don't worry, Modi will bring some regulation there.
Television series goes beyond 3 to 4 years, 5 years. Web series is limited number of maybe 25 or 50 series.
Television series is aimed at a
tomorrow, particular... your student might be a director. Okay, we'll go ahead and become a director, creative director. Okay, so he might come and ask you, what is the difference between these two? How would you go about and present him?
Television series is
budget also matters.
Hello.
Budget also matters.
Okay, budget. Okay, what else? You say, tell your student, oh, if you have good budget, then do a web series. If you have little budget, then you do a television series. No, budget might be, one of the factors.
Yes.
How do you do that?
And also broadcasting limit also, sir.
Okay, broadcasting. Example, there are rules and regulations in the broadcast. Yes. Okay, fine. What else?
Time slots are also matters. When it comes to the television, there is a certain prime time for serials or soap operas.
It is what we call it as on-demand content. Okay.
Yes.
When television, when they broadcast at whatever time, okay, we are supposed to see that. Okay. Vis-a-vis with on-demand content. Whenever I want, I can watch the content. Right or wrong? Now, what am I doing with this whole exercise is the what we get into something called project-based learning. Are we clear? So I am just throwing an idea or some random idea about a difference between this television series and web series, and suddenly this, what you call it as, discussion starts happening. The discussion might be an inquiry-based approach, or it can be a problem-based approach. Actually, I have a problem, okay? I work in the night shifts, but this particular television series is coming at a particular part of the time where I'm working actually. So I cannot see this television series. I cannot view this film or whatever, okay? That's a problem I am facing, okay? For which I need a solution. That solution would be, okay, on-demand content. I want to see that content whenever I feel so, okay? Now, this is what we have to do going forward, whether we like it or not. This project-based learning is what is touted by the new vice chancellor. Okay, how do we actually implement project-based learning? When we talk about project-based learning, then we have to have a two specific approaches, that is inquiry-based learning, okay, or problem-based approach. Okay, so I give a throw a challenge, okay. And I say, we are facing this kind of difficulty. How would I go about? Then find a solution. Otherwise, we will all die. Okay, that is like the COVID is there. If you get out of the house, the COVID will come and kill you. Find a solution to the COVID. Okay, so everyone, suddenly you find that the whole project of finding a vaccination, effective vaccination, happens. So normally a vaccination takes 10 years to come out effectively. Suddenly we find vaccination coming out after 6 months or 1 year. So this is the open kind of challenge. Now with the student also, you can work out in a certain way. You can throw a challenge. Okay, guys, you have 3 years. In this 3 years, you are going to make a 2D animated movie, 3D animated movie, visual effects movie, or a game-based this. So you can throw broad challenges individually what you can do. At the maximum, you can do some 10 seconds ad effectively. Okay, 20 seconds ad effectively, 1 or 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes. These are the kind of time constraints you have where you can individually contribute. Or you can come collectively and make a movie, for a short movie for 15 minutes or 20 minutes. So when you talk about project-based learning or project-centric learning, okay, why student today doesn't take, even you say, I have a problem in the classroom, and students are distracted because they don't find any connect with what, where they have to apply, how they have to apply. When they don't have that clarity in the connect, okay, they disconnect from you. Okay. When they don't see any useful purpose of immediate application or long-term application, okay, for a particular set of facts or knowledge or skill being presented as a teacher, okay, they disconnect. Okay, people disconnect either because they have language issues. Okay, I am not from traditional English speaking elite. No, certainly not. I have to acquire this proficiency. Okay, so same way some students are, their thought process is in their native language. They are in, say, somebody would be thinking in Bengali, somebody in thinking in Hindi, Tamil, you name it. That's how their thought process are structured. Okay, when you start throwing ideas at them in English, okay, there is a transmission loss. By the time they understand and they respond and they start building the construct, okay, it becomes a Herculean affair. And that's how they get disconnected in the classroom. So first, it can be a language issue. Okay, they're not able to connect with what you are trying to transmit, what you are trying to convey. Okay, so whether you like it or not, you cannot administer 1:1 guidance. It is 1:25, but from the project-based learning perspective, look at the, do a SWOT analysis of the entire cohort. That is, it can be 30 people or 40, whatever is the batch strength, okay? Look at the strengths and weaknesses of individual and start putting together a group, okay? So that it is manageable. They say, when you tell, I forget. When you show, I remember. when you involve, I understand. So most of the time we keep telling. Okay. They just hear, forget. This is what is going to happen. You show them, yes, the remembrance is there. Okay. Today, when I say COVID virus, then you immediately that spear will come with a lot of the blotches in it. Okay. The shape becomes very prominent in our mental eye. Okay. That is what image does. When I talk to you in COVID or whatever, say I talk any random word, okay, immediately a image construct happens and you are able to relate. Okay. So that is where, so people blindly do a lot of things in classroom. Okay. They say digitization, okay, they will start showing YouTube videos. They will start recording their classroom sessions and they will start digitizing the sprint content, and they say these are the self-learning materials. What I do not know, okay, what self-learning material it is. Okay, it's just a rip-off from some text. Be clear. So, and they say, oh, we are having a fantastic classroom environment, everything is digitized, we have interaction, it is so beautiful. Oh yeah, okay. Lekin hamare isme nahi chalta. It doesn't work out. It doesn't work out at all. Okay. Because we have a huge problem ki how the information is getting perceived. Okay. I still remember one of the earlier advisors that came to our way is, you please show YouTube videos. At least 2 YouTube videos should be there in the classroom. That's what the mandate was. So we also mapped and put, because most of the time what I do is last 6 years, at least 1 semester in a year and 1 subject I go and take personally, just to see that what this higher order thinking, whatever we sit in the leadership, whatever we think vis-a-vis what is happening on the ground. Okay. It's totally different. Okay. We might have brilliant ideas that an investor would love it. Okay. Eat from the palm of our hands. Oh, wow. We are that. We do all kind of gimmicks that an investor will get attracted and will say, okay, here is the 10 crores, take 10, 20 crores, 30 crores. This is the game I have been playing for quite a long time. Okay. We know how to impress the audience. Okay. Of so-called informed, highly educated, financially savvy investors. Okay. Uska presentation alag rehta hai, but there is on the ground, things are totally different. Okay. I still remember one student got up and told me, okay, now that they are showing videos in the classroom and all, is it interesting? They told, sir, we are paying 1.5 lakhs, sir. Why should I watch a YouTube video in the classroom? That was the first. I loved it. The way she put it, I loved it. Okay. This is the practical impossibility that we face when it comes to implementation. So we think this is the best solution. Okay. This is the vaccine that will give you 90% cure for COVID, but its effectiveness would not even be 20%. You don't even know. Okay. How many of us know that already 70% population, only not even 1% global population is affected, or not even 1.5% people have died in India, but India is shut down because of this COVID scare. Okay. People simply panic and they say, okay, people are dying. Yes, people are dying. Even without COVID, they were dying 7 per minute or 8 per minute, whatever it is. With COVID also, people are dying with a particular comorbidities. Those who have some comorbidities like diabetes or something like that, they are dying. Okay, they have VP. So you can as well say, okay, those who are having comorbidities, you be very careful. You wear a mask. Don't go outside. Don't socialize. Whereas the rest of the 70% who are immune, okay, by default, they are immune. That's why otherwise India will not have 1 crore case. Now it has just in another 20,000 is required for 1 crore infections in India, 136 crores. 136 crores mein 1 crore ka infection hua. Usme 1.5% people mare usme. But it is being projected in such a way that, oh, people are dying as they are all falling on the road and dying. Okay. That's the kind of the power of the media. You understand? So now it's very all the more important when we talk about all this, we get certain insights. We can take any common problem. When we start discussing about it, we get certain insights that gives a big picture. Okay. Okay. This is how it is. So it's all the more important when you are discussing any of the concepts. Whenever assignments you are presenting to the students, okay, make them feel connected. see that there is a real world solution coming out of it. If it is not there, you will have a very boring session in the classroom. Okay. So now with that, we'll proceed to what we wish to cover this session. Most of it I do not want to repeat. Okay. Rather, I would ask you certain basic, constructs. What is difference between an aim and a goal? Anybody? Aim and a goal.
Goal, it should be reachable. So either it's a short-term goal, it's achievable. Short-term goal or long-term goal.
Sir, can I say something?
Yeah, go ahead. It's open. It's like Arnav show. Okay, go ahead.
So aim means in NHR policy, whatever content development is there. So every contents we are providing the aims means those are subject or product we are creating or we are preparing. First, we are representing the product. These are the aims which we have to cover in this topic, in this subject. And goal means after outcomes, means whatever I have provided after that, what kind of outcome or productivity will come from the students. That is the goal.
Anybody? Yeah, you can Google it out also. Don't worry. Okay.
Well, sir, may I say something? I mean,
yeah, ma.
I'm giving this response a bit subjective perhaps. Aim is very specific. Goal can be imagined as not so specific. It may have many aspects where you or we want to reach. I mean, in different contexts, I'm giving very naive example. If I am an archer,
who is this?
Dipoman, sir.
Dipoman. Okay, Dipoman, you are getting it wrong. The other way around, ma.
Okay.
Yeah, please go through it because understand the jargons. Okay. Mm-hmm. What is objective? What is outcome? Okay. Mm-hmm. What is a aim? What is a goal?
Yes.
If we say aim, it is a kind of a generic in approach. Okay, nothing specific.
Yes,
very,
course.
Very long term. Okay. So when you are playing, say, football, okay, mm-hmm. in the aim of the you used to win the match. Okay, that's a very generic approach. Okay?
Yes.
When you say goal, you know where the goalposts are. Mm-hmm. Okay. Only when the ball goes inside there, the opponent's goalpost, it's a goal. Are we clear? Mm-hmm. Then it becomes very specific. Okay. Mm-hmm. It's a very, what you call it as a very time bound and very short term in approach. Are we clear? Okay. Mm-hmm. So when you are actually going towards the goal, okay, this is the strategy I will follow, Bulke, towards making that goal happen. Okay. That is what we call it as objectives, the milestones. Are we clear about this?
Yes. I was just okay.
So go through every, if you see, however well read you are, okay. You might be PhDs or whatever it is. At the end of it, okay, we are dealing with an alien language called English. Okay. It has its own quixotic nature, okay, where we are not thoroughly grounded with the language. So sometimes we get confused. Okay. Everything looks same. Aim is same. Goal is goal. Objective is objective. Outcome is outcome. Well, objective. So when you generalize, it all looks similar, but certainly not same. Are you clear about this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Me, like,
so first open the dictionary,
open
the Google and start finding out what this name exactly represents. What is this program outcome? What is this program objective? What is this this evaluation patterns? Okay. When you say each and everything, okay, in terms of, don't feel otherwise, just, it's a process. If I certainly have to deal with some Japanese or from Chinese due to whatsoever reason, I have to go through those documentation. Of course, I might need an interpreter, but more than interpreter, I would be very much worried what each and every word they are putting in the clause. Okay, because it's alien language. Okay, however we think we are familiar with the language, better be careful because you are all experts in whatever you do and whatever you teach. Okay, whatever skill you have. But when it comes to any administrator coming and auditing, okay, they will not catch on what your objectives in terms of what you are delivering in the classroom, what you are skilling or what is your talent, they won't do that. Okay, they will catch you on why the objective is like this, why the outcome is like this. This is because many audits we face, okay, or many board of studies I attend. Okay, most of the time, okay, the questions would be, oh, how many credits, how the credits are distributed, what is done, how much weightage you are given to non-specific, discipline-specific electives, how much weightage you are giving to languages, blah, 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 blah. Most of the time, you will be answering to certain unknowns, okay, for of which they are very familiar. Okay, they might not be domain experts, but they will be able to extract a degree of control over you by knowing all this. Okay, so understand the rule book thoroughly. To understand the rule book thoroughly, understand the nuances involved in the rule book. Are we clear? I know it is a long drawn process, but most of the time these are the queries that comes across when it comes to auditing. Okay, so better be clear about this. So just have worked up a sample, each one based on your requirements. Okay, you can improvise. Okay, because at the end of it, university might have its own analogy about how this vision and mission statements would be there, because everything, like the other day when we had attended the seminar from the vice chancellor, so they are yet to give firm directions on what the vision and missions are. Okay, from there everything gets worked out. Okay, so when I talk about vision and mission, okay, be very clear what our vision is for this particular program called animation, visual effects, gaming and filmmaking. All these are encompassed in the terms of media and entertainment. Okay, how do we as a school, as a department, okay, create certain distinct identity, why this is required. When I talk about India having 136 crore population and with the active viewing public of content around 850 million or 900 million, we do not have a single university provides that kind of solutions for training the resources. Because based on the projects I delivered earlier, be it Little Krishna, Resident Evil or whatever, the visual effects projects, okay, what we found lacking was the trained resource. Where do I get the trained resource? I will get from AppTech or what you call Arenas and Framebox. That's where this trained resources used to come. They used to train for 6 months, 9 months, and they used to land on our lap. Okay. For next 3 years or 5 years, we have to train them to be internationally acceptable. Indian context may, they will get accepted within a 9 months or 10 months, but for international projects to be handled very well, okay, it requires at least a couple of years. So we have to invest that kind of effort on a resource to make them acceptable or make them productive. So many IPs failed. IP, when I say, when we did our own intellectual property, our products, okay, in the Indian market, we failed because of lack of talent, because there was no vision when it comes to how do I train the resource. There was no mission, how would I go about with this process of training. Okay, so we used to, I still remember for Little Krishna project, we went all around Maharashtra. We picked up whomsoever can draw very well, okay, from the art schools there that were in remote towns. Okay, from there we picked up, and the next 1 year, 1.5 years went in training them. They don't even know what software is, what computer is. From there we had to really teach them, and by the time they could be productive, the company shut down. Okay, because they had committed some 300, 400 crores. And most of the time, because what can be done and delivered by some 150, 200 talented people, we ended up delivering with 750 odd people. Sooner or later, somebody pulled the plug. Okay. And the recession came in 2008 and it pulled the plug. So when I analyze and go back, it is because of lack of quality talent, because there is no adequate background in terms of they doing adequate training, at least for 5 years, 10 years before joining the industry. Okay. So this is where we lack, because Indian schooling system also, if you look at the drawing, is not a made or a storytelling or a drawing. It is not given major focus. After 6th standard or 7th standard, it is sidelined. That's how the effective thinking in terms of be it product or independent thinking or independent creation process dies down. Okay. So you have millions of engineers coming out, not even single engineering product coming out, just because last 8 years, we don't have a single engineering product from India. Okay, that can be called world-class. Okay, so the mobiles, what you use from maybe from China, from Korea, from Japan or whatever. Okay, most of them are Chinese products. So all this happens just because we don't have an independent critical thinking system. So what essentially, when I say we have to have these components put in place in training, especially in university and in schooling system. Okay. Now, how do you go about the whole process? If you have attended the VC seminar, you would, I think Rini has the
recordings.
Yeah, the recordings. Okay. Those who have not attended, go through it. Okay. So tomorrow, if suddenly VC comes and audits, okay, you should be familiar with what he has conveyed. Okay, so go through, take some time out and go through it. It's very interesting. So you can go through that. So essentially, I've just consulted and put it across. What is their thought process? Is vision and mission, obviously. Okay, then the program educational objectives, then program outcomes, course outcomes. When I say course, from now onwards, you remember course is a subject. Earlier we used to call subjects in a semester. That is called course. BSc Animation Visual Effects is a program. Okay, so understand. So for each program, you have certain outcomes and certain objectives. And for each course within that program, you have certain outcomes. Okay, that's how this has been segregated. So this is the overall broad plan. Okay, in terms of second part is the assessment. What the new VC has come out is he wants to include assessment as a part of TLP. When I started out, teaching learning plan was a big joke. Okay. It was a document that needs to be filled by faculties. And essentially what they used to do is to pick up all the topics in a particular module and start putting it and allocating certain hours to it. And they used to conclude it as a teaching learning plan. Okay. So from there, yes. And the first news I had was with the KL University, where they implemented some 6 years before what the Jain is implementing today, okay, in terms of this OBE, okay. So, yes, that is a very, very, very fine blueprint, okay, how the course has to be delivered or how the program has to be delivered, okay. So all the stakeholders, irrespective of whichever domain they come, they should easily understand what is being taught, how it is being taught, how it is being assessed, okay. So when it comes to assessment, at the end of it, when we run a skill-based program, we're essentially looking at them gainfully employed, okay? So for gainful employment, it doesn't happen overnight. It has to happen in incremental way, okay? So what you do on day-to-day basis, be it in assignments or projects, what they do every semester or as a part of the particular semester, okay? That should lead into final outcome in terms of they getting a job. So all our assessments are based on how effective they are. If your assessments are very good, then definitely there should not be a placement department out there doing the hard work. The students automatically get placed. Just like that it happens. Okay. Like how it happens in all premium institutions. They don't have to work very hard. They are, rather the companies are waiting in line and paying them 80 lakhs, 90 lakhs package. Okay, if you typically look at IITs and certain NIDs, and they get very good packages, around 80 lakhs to 1 crore or 1.2 crore package per year, just by the sheer fact that, yes, that guy is talented. Okay, if a company is investing 80 lakhs or 1 crore on a particular resource, then look at, they are looking at something like 50 crores or 30 crores from that person. Okay, it is as simple as logic. That's why they invest that on the resource. So it is very important when you are doing this assessments properly. Okay, at least they would be decently placed statements and simple mission statements. How do I go about it? If the vision is a broad perspective to become a global leader offering world-class education in the field of filmmaking, animation, visual effects, gaming industry, and proactively engage with the industry and adapt to rapid changes in technology landscape. Okay. When it comes to media, when we talk about filmmaking, okay, it can be fiction, non-fiction. Animation, it can be on a 2D platform, 3D platform, or in in stereoscopic, whatever you call it, or visual effects, or for that matter, the gaming industry. Okay, so how do we train the resources there and be a global leader in this kind of industry? Okay, so we do fantastically well when it comes to services industry. Say, if you look at Infosys, or for that matter, Wipro, TCS, okay, all the engineering, 900 odd engineering colleges, okay, or sorry, millions of engineering students coming out, they're essentially trained to be service providers, okay, cheap manual labor, okay, where they might be going into low order work in terms of coding and rather than to high order work of designing, okay. So our whole education industry is geared to deliver to this requirement. So if China is in manufacturing, we are into services. And our education system that has been designed by Macaulay over two centuries back or a century old, okay. So they required clerks. That's how we still produce clerks, okay, who do what they are told. They do not have any critical thinking or independent thinking. So how do I change that? Because if I say 136 crore people are watching content, I cannot keep copying the content like Kaun Banega Crorepati, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, Indian Idol, American Idol. Every program, every movie that is coming out, okay, most of them are getting are cheap copies of some Hollywood flicks or from Korean or from Chinese. Wherever you find many of the flicks getting copied because we don't have a robust training setup. Okay, that's what as a vision, we have to create global leaders offering, be a global leader offering world-class education. Okay, then how do I go with this? Offer world-class education, develop highly skilled professionals in so-and-so field. Undertake research to create cutting-edge knowledge in the above areas. Then foster an ecosystem of startups, entrepreneurship in animation, visual effects industry. Okay, so that is what will make us a global leader. Okay, when say Steven Spielberg makes a movie, it goes to 40,000, 50,000 screens. When a Maniratnam or some prominent Indian director makes a movie, it goes to some 2,000 screens or some 5,000 screens. So there's a huge, huge gap in terms of the reach, just because we are not there where we create products that is internationally acceptable. Okay, so it's all the more important for us to, as a robust, we have, see, if you look at our 136 crore population, it is close to some 50, 60 country population put together. Okay, so that's not a joke. With that kind of customer base we have, and we don't make independent product, it's a highly shameful. So it is very important for us to create that and foster that within our education system. Okay, these are the core mission. Okay. Now comes the program educational objective. Okay, so what I'm trying to do this time, thing, most of the time you would have heard a generalized approach, okay, be it from the end or from Dr. Nachappa's end. Okay, so how do I tailor make to our requirement in terms of objectives for whatever programs we are pursuing? So you can make changes here and there to suit your requirements. But these are the broad program objectives. Say, take for example, if I'm running an animation visual effects program, the program will produce graduates who will be competent ideators in advertisement, animation, visual effects industry. Okay, the graduates will be able to adapt to fast changing technology landscapes. Earlier, the technologies were there for 20, 30 years. From black and white to color, you can see some 60, 80 years difference before the color took over, okay? But today, if you look at every 6 months, the technology keeps changing, okay? The possibilities are enormous. Today, we have augmented reality and virtual reality coming in a big way, or mixed reality is coming in a big way, but we do not have filmmakers who can adapt to that environment. Traditional filmmakers, they work in a certain way, okay? And they have been doing this practice for the last 30, 40 years in a certain way. They find it very difficult to adapt to the new requirements. So the students essentially whom you are teaching might be the future directors who can really make a mark in this upcoming technologies. So that is where we discuss about the fast changing technology landscapes. The graduates will become effective collaborators through innovation methodologies and storytelling. They'll be able to address the social, technical, business challenges and opportunities. So when I say talk about this, our storytelling is the oldest profession. People say animation is a new profession, or visual effects is a new profession, or for that matter, gaming is a new profession. But when we talk about our industry, okay, we have, our industry is close to some 10,000, 20,000 years. That's what it made a human as a species made a difference from other animals. We are very good storytellers. Okay, later it was audio. Orally, we used to transmit this kind of story. That has, technology has made a marked improvement. That's all. Okay, so ours is one of the oldest professions. Okay, so when it comes to we being the oldest profession, okay, and the technology that is coming, and how do I experience the content? Okay, that's more important. So that's where we become collaborators. And most of the time when we create product in the industry, I find that most of them do not understand the other's requirement. A storyteller, when you are writing for a, he doesn't understand what is the visual effects requirement, or what is the requirement in terms of modeling, or he doesn't understand a gaming designer essentially has to have a firm grip on all the areas, storytelling, technology, design, all these areas he should have a firm grip. But if our education system we offer in a silos, okay, some teach only programming, some teach only design, some teach only the technology component in terms of the softwares that we use. So when we silo it, it is very good as far as service markets are concerned, okay, because we are addressing to a particular silo, okay, to service. So most of the time we do animation work, or we do the composting, roto keying, track painting, paint, and all this composting works. So for that silo approach in terms of services, it is good. But when I want to make a movie like Bahubali, or for that matter, any of this effects-based movies, that is where the problem starts. So when I look at Bahubali, every other frame is having a problem. Okay, every other scene is having a problem. Either there is a light direction issue or a shadow issue, you name it. Okay, where when they place a CG object, we have a huge issue in terms of how it is blending with the environment. Okay, for India, it might be a great spectacle, but internationally, Bahubali will not sell, just for the fact that technically it is not there. Okay, storytelling is not of that great maturity. Okay, so in India, it can earn 1,500 crores or 2,000 crores, but this is as good as a global movie. But when you look at the global markets, the acceptance is very less. Maybe the Chinese are doing extremely good today. If you look at, they have started Golden Harvest way back some 50, 60 years before, right from the Bruce Lee. They know their strength, and accordingly, they have come out with the products. Okay, so India has not made a mark just for the fact that, well, we did not understand what is the how to tell stories internationally that can be acceptable internationally. Okay, so we don't understand technology that is acceptable. Okay, so these are the issues that we face. That's where we fail as a product, okay, creators. Okay, we fail on high order jobs. Okay, so these are the attributes that we want to incorporate in terms of skilling in the university system itself, so that they have a broad idea about other areas other than what they are interested in, and they can connect and run well. Okay. So I will not get into the product outcome program outcome, just for the fact that different universities have different. Some say I want 15 outcomes. Some say I want 10 outcomes. Some say I want 8 outcomes. Okay. I will not get into it because it is adaptable. Okay. Again, it depends on the vision and mission, how a university wants to go ahead. Okay. If some university wants to focus on entrepreneurship and all that, they would be bringing a lot of elements from finance and marketing background also as a part of your course, program study. Okay. So again, the program outcome will vary. And some university will be focused only on the technology part of it, and they would not be worried about other aspects. So they want to create technically very good people, okay, who are technically very sound. Okay, their priorities might be different. So accordingly, their non-discipline specific electives might be different. Okay, some people would be environmentally conscious, or they want to be socially very the awareness should be there. So whatever programs, courses they bring, accordingly we have to look at the outcome, because we are looking at the overall program and the outcome. So what all subjects or courses that is involved in it, accordingly we have to plan the outcome. Okay, be it the languages, we have to incorporate languages. We have to incorporate, say, Indian Constitution, or for that matter, you have so many UGC guided specific program, this thing, courses to be included. So we need to look at overall holistically, and accordingly, we have to give the outcome. Okay. So these are the broad outcomes that we have given. Okay, you can modify to the requirement looking at your specific programs. So any questions so far? Hello?
No, sir.
All have slept or?
No, sir, no.
Sir, it relates to you were telling about the story design mythology. Actually, you know, one of the book is actually very famous for that. Actually, there was this, there is this one book called as Dune, which is actually authored by Frank Herbert, which was released in the 1970s as such, the novel. But, you know, all the filmmakers right from 80s and 90s, they were not able to visualize that novel because the scenarios which were actually depicted in that particular book was not feasible to create at that particular time. Yeah. A huge set. There, actually, there's one scene where there's a 100-foot worm that needs to be created. 100-foot worm.
Okay.
So in that book, it is there actually. So they tried it out. They tried, they released a movie in 1980s or such, but it didn't turn out to as per the expectation of the book. But I think in 2021, they are releasing that movie, sir. Finally, that particular book has been visualized, and they are releasing it in the market next year. The same thing, one more is also there, that is called as Rendezvous with Rama, which is authored by Arthur C. Clarke.
Mm-hmm.
Even that is also novel-wise, if we try to visualize it, that actually becomes a very good exercise for students also. Like, you know, just read that one paragraph of content and try to visualize the world in a form of concept art. It brings out a lot of options. Even that is also very difficult to actually visualize as a picture in a visual format. These two books are.
Yeah. See, one thing we have to be practical about our outlook. When I am designing a program, I am looking at the lowest of low in terms of whatever capabilities the society judges, okay, in a student, okay. Most of the time we get recruits from that area where they have failed in other areas. They think animation, visual effects, gaming or filmmaking is an easier option, so they come and join us. So usually we call them as bottom feeders. Okay, most of them are bottom feeders, okay, or the misfits from the traditional education system. Okay, they come to us and we have to accommodate them. We have to make them, a sustainable career has to be made available for them. So when we are designing the programs, we are looking at the, from the bottom feeders to the people with highest talent, whatever it is, natural talent. So, and the education system, I find it very funny. We have attended enough examination, this thing, no? What do you call that? Review. What do you call that, Rini?
Audit.
We have this now. What do you call that?
BOE.
No, result analysis. Sorry.
Result analysis.
It's a big standing joke. Okay. When earlier, when people fail, when a student fails, okay, whatsoever, in the examination or lack of attendance, their parents would be called and they would be questioned what kind of ward you have. Okay. Today, the teacher is responsible why a student failed. Okay, this is the very, very anomaly that we have to face today. And when we say they are not attending the class, then they say you are not taking interesting sessions.
Yes.
Why they are not attending? Okay, when they fail to appear for the examination, they say you have to go and find out why he did not fail to attend the examination. Okay, and when they fail in the examination, he told you purposefully, you have been very, very spiteful. That's why you failed him in the examination. You name it, we have it. Okay. So today a parent also says, look, I have paid 1.5 lakhs. How can student, my son fail or my daughter fail. Okay, so these are the scenarios that was unimaginable some 2-3 decades back, but today it's a reality out there. So somewhere around line we have to have a rethinking. Okay, one assessment patterns is not correct. Okay, there should be a continuous assessment. Okay, when you teach a module or when you go through a module, you take it step by step. When continuous assessment happens, we know how the student is progressing in terms of skilling or learning. But at the same time, yeah, as a teacher, you face this kind of piquant issues where you don't have any answers. When suddenly you are questioned, you are not prepared for this kind of outcomes in a session. Okay, so it is all the more important for us when we are designing a program. These are the questions that would be, if I have to design a program for an IIT or say NID, okay, I will do it in a certain way because I have the choice of students whom I take. Okay, so the talent pool, I have the choice. But when it comes to the universities, okay, private universities, okay, it is more from a business perspective. Whomsoever comes and they take the admission, whatsoever, okay, we are supposed to go with them and see that they are gainfully employed. So when you are designing the program, it becomes very tricky. Why I put certain subjects or how it is just because, yes, we have to look at the bottom feeders. Okay, so roto might not be a important skill from the perspective of a design. Okay, but still roto would be there because jobs are available. Okay, paint might not be a very high order skill, but paint is required because a lot of people get employed in paint. Okay, so we have to look at the overall holistically, what is our intake? Okay, what is the quality of intake? Accordingly, we have to again raise the bar or lower the bar. So when you do project-based learning or project-centric learning, okay, you can design certain assignments. Okay, the assignments can be individual assignments or assignment can be a group projects. Okay, with this thought process, you can keep all the people involved, all the stakeholders involved. Okay, and certainly I have a view that nobody is born dumb or intelligent. It is just a level of interest. If you are passionate about picking up a particular skill, if you are a genius or whatever, you might pick up very quickly. Or if you are not a genius, you have to spend enough hours, but you will get it. Okay, that's my thought process. Okay, so it is very important for us when you are putting giving an assignment or giving a project, look at the, do a SWOT analysis of the student cohort. Accordingly, you put them together. And this has to happen very early in their schooling. Okay, when we say in the first semester itself, it has to start in a certain way. So they get used to each other. And you put a guy who is very talented and certain people who, if you push, they do very well, and certain bottom figures together and motivate them to come out with certain outcomes. Slowly we can see that with the involvement, what I spoke earlier about what I tell, what I see, what I involve. Okay, that way we can involve them. That's where they can pick up their skills. Even the least motivated will become really, it is one of the good strategies to get them involved. So that way it becomes a proper project-centric learning. Are we clear? Okay. So now, how to go about with the TLPs? How to go about with the TLPs? Rini, you have done for one particular based on the JEE requirement, right?
Yes, sir.
Would you like to present? Then I will again get into the.
Sure, sir.
Ma'am, I have given access. You can check.
Yeah. Okay. I think sir has to stop sharing. Dinesh, sir, you have to stop sharing.
There you go. New share is there. Pause share or stop share. Yeah.
Stop share.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. I think I have shared this document also with everyone, so that they can do it for their respective subjects. So I had done this for one topic, which is my subject on compositing techniques. And see, all these are normal only, whatever you have as per the course matrix. And then there are some objectives and outcomes. Now, objectives, as I received the feedback from sir, needs to refine a little bit more. So that he said we can do later on also. But roughly, I have just put this, which the content of which is fine, but the moderation, the way it has to be written, needs to be modified a little bit more.
Okay. So can you elaborate on objectives and outcome? Who does the objective refer to? When we say objectives, we set for a particular course. Okay, who does it refer to?
Yeah, it refers to the teacher. So when we are talking about objectives, it is about what we are thinking as a teacher. What is our objective? With what mindset do we come, or what is it that is there in our minds when we want to teach this particular course? So that is what is objective from the teacher point of view. And when we come to outcomes, that is the student point of view. What will the students be able to do after they finish this course? Or the subject, as in a course, as sir already told you, that course should now be considered as a subject. Okay.
Reni ma'am, here, yeah. Sorry for the interruption. A course objective, teachers, like particular subject point
subject.
Of view.
Yes,
point of
absolutely. View. Course objective is subject. Yes. That's why it's written course objective, which means that particular subject objective. So if we are doing this from, like, let's say for this particular example over here, we're doing it for compositing techniques. So what, according to me as a teacher or like teaching this particular subject of compositing techniques, what is my objective? What is it that I want my students to learn from this?
No, it's not according to you, ma'am. It's according to the according syllabus the course, of the particular syllabus. Particular syllabus. Yes. The teacher has to create the objective.
I have one more point.
Someone else is designing the syllabus, and the teacher, how he can fix that course objective and all, because those who are creating the syllabus, they should know better, and they should write all these things, right? Because they are the one, they are creating the syllabus.
No, okay. Actually, sir, course objective should be learning objective. What is the objective of teacher with respect to student? What we are going to learn in entire yes. course duration. This yes. is, it should be learning objective. Each and every university are changing the things.
The terminologies are changed accordingly. Right.
So that is what I'm saying. See, learning objective and whatever teaching objective, that is different. But here they have mentioned course and course objective means
I had an answer for you, sir. As a teacher, being a subject expert, you should know.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not saying I don't know. What I'm saying is the terminology, whatever we used here, this is not what you people are you're saying. That is not matching. That is what my point.
No, sir. Matching means it has to match as per the Bloom's taxonomy. The framing and everything has to match as per the Bloom's taxonomy. But the subject, you are only the subject matter expert now, as in you are expert in that subject now. So what you will know best now, what you want your students to learn.
See, that's what I'm asking. Someone else is creating syllabus. So we don't know like what kind of mindset he created that syllabus. See, I'm a subject expert. Suppose I have some issue with the syllabus. Then what to do? How to approach?
Sir, so far as if we have a
talk. Okay, just a moment. I want to interject here.
Yeah,
okay, Gokul. Okay. That's where we have something called BOS.
Yeah.
Okay. Where everything is adequately addressed in terms of all stakeholders having a say in it. Okay. So the end of it, you are telling the program. Okay. Your interpretation of the truth. Okay. So a cockroach sees the world. Okay, it has also eyes. It sees the world. Okay, and a donkey also sees the world. Okay, it has also its eye, and a human also sees the world. Maybe some intelligent alien life is also seeing the world. Okay, each one the reality is important. Their reality is true. Are we clear? Their reality is true. What they see is true. Okay, that doesn't necessarily reflect that a cockroach reality is the reality of the a human. Okay, if you ask what is true, everyone is true in their own perspective. Okay, when it comes to course delivery also, how we look at the overall view, what I am supposed to deliver, that is where the democratization of content happens. Earlier it was all done and dusted, and it was told just it goes for implementation. That's how our education system was. Okay, there would be no review of syllabus or no review of course material, or for that matter any of the program objectives. Okay, for 15 to 20 years, I can see show you certain documentation from certain universities, okay, which has not changed for last 2 decades. They still run the multimedia programs the way it was run some two decades before. Okay, so that is where the UGC or for that matter AICTE, they told how much grades you are bringing to the syllabus and conforming to the requirements, okay, current requirements. So everyone has a say. Okay, it is like when a director directs a movie, okay, audience sees it, everyone has a take. They like it, they don't like it, they have a take, okay. But you can, as a viewer or as a guy who is going to implement what UGC says today, you have a say. You tell, okay, this is what is required, or this can be cut down, this is not there widely practiced now, or these are the trends that is picking up. You have every right to say, okay, I don't get to hear anything, okay, when it comes to syllabus review from any of my faculty members. Sir, how about this? Why not we add this? Why not we add that? No, nothing comes. Okay, that is where the problem is. It is very easy to pick up, okay, this is not right, that is not right, or this should be added, that should be added. Now, what effort did I put to convey that? That is very essential, because I hardly find any mails coming and saying, okay, this is how it has been designed. Can we do this? Okay, as a part of this year, because every year they are now introducing. Earlier, we were given that once you design for 3-5 years, you cannot change. The same JNU University gave me a mandate some 5-6 years before. They told you cannot change anything in the syllabus. Whatever remains the same. I told how every 6 months I have a new technology landscape coming in. How can I not upgrade my syllabus? Then they told, look, certain students fail, and we have to conduct the examinations. If you keep changing the syllabus, then the controller of examination find it very difficult. He cannot frame a separate question paper for that. You cannot do this. Please don't do that. Okay. So I ended up inheriting a syllabus that has been there for quite a long time. Okay. And I could not make changes for next year. Whatever I inherited, I had to follow. Okay. So these are the operational difficulties we face. But what we did was, okay, while I have a handicap in terms of me not able to change to the current requirements, we can effectively deal with it in terms of workshops. That's where we went a via round. Okay, if this particular topic is not getting adequately covered or this is not getting addressed, let us do a workshop. Let us do a online session or whatever it is. So the whole concept of this was based on this handicap that we faced. Okay.
Yeah, sir, I agree. But my main point is, suppose you are giving one syllabus to one particular teacher. Maybe he is not an expert in that subject. Maybe somehow he is managing. So if he fix these core subjects and all, so how can we judge? How can we say that is the correct one? There should be a monitor committee, and maybe above the teacher, someone else have to look all these core subjectives and all. That is what my point, because if the teacher is fixing, whatever he knows, he will fix simply. So that is my point.
That actually is there, no sir. That is there. Of course, after we are doing it, it is going to, first of all, it is going to our HO, which is, it is going through the revision of Dinesh sir only. And once it is revised by him, then we also have Nachappa sir. We are sending it to Nachappa sir parallelly. Once these two reviews are done, then it is finally sent to the VC. So it is finally going to the university, where if they require any changes, then they are putting in those changes. So yeah, revisions are there, sir. It is not that what you are giving is the, you know, is written in stone and cannot be altered. Aisa kuch nahi. As in, it's not like
no,
that.
No, if it is like that, then that's fine. But because
yeah.
What,
yes,
what
sir.
I thought, like whatever the teacher is fixing, that is the final.
No, sir. That is the reason why we have asked for the TLEPs so early, because once we get the TLEPs, then we can send it to HO. So all the TLEPs by yesterday itself was the deadline, and all the TLEPs have already reached the HO. They are now going through it. Dinesh sir himself is going through all of them, and then it will be again will be sent to Nachappa sir for his further interpretation or whatever corrections he has to do, and then finally it will go to the university.
Okay, then it's fine. Then
yeah, yes. So that's the reason I told you in the very beginning that course objectives I have. Sorry, yes, sir.
Local and others have reservations on this. Okay, learn to do this. Okay, yes. If you want to going forward, this is an essential skill if you want to be a part of it.
No. See, okay. My point is, I'm ready to do. I'm doing it. My point is, I don't know. There is a monitor committee, and they are going to check. Who will going to check? So that point and all, I'm not clear. So just now I cleared it. That's it.
You have a SME in Vivek Vallabhdas. Okay, discuss with him. When you are as a pre-production, you have a SME. As a game, you have a SME in Ajay. Okay, you have a Rufus with you. Go and talk to them. Look, I have an issue. Is it the way? Because they deal with other universities also. Okay, they can call the. Put together the experience and direct you. Okay, most of the time we are not ready to interact with anyone. Okay, so that is where we restrict ourselves. Okay, so. But you have to go through this. What you know, you have to do. What you do not know, you attempt.
Yes.
Tomorrow you would be head of the department. Not every subject would be your cup of tea. Okay, you might have to deal with some mixed reality as part of your program delivery. Okay, of which you will not have a clue of what M is, what R is. Okay, but still you have to see whether things are shaped. So when you face that kind of issues, then your entrenched knowledge in what you know. Okay, then vis-a-vis with what is being put across, that's where you take decisions and say, okay, this is how we are go about. Okay.
Fine.
Next.
Right. Okay. Just in addition to what Dhresh sir just now said, sir, to be very honest, I do not belong to this education background at all. I come absolutely from the production background. So all these terms, when I first met Dinesh sir, he spoke about Bloom's taxonomy, it went on top of my head. I said, what am I doing? I don't even know what these are. And today I am designing this. I did not know how to do it. I did one with whatever knowledge I had. I shared it with Nachappa sir, and fortunately it got approved. So it's just trial and error. So it's not big deal. Don't worry about it. And this is one thing, people are talking so much about PO and PSOs and course objective, course outcome. Don't get panicked about it is one thing that I want to tell. Because I'm telling you from my own experience. This is not for you. This is for everyone.
I will clarify first. Yeah. See, this is, I'm not asking because of, I have any doubt regarding this. No, not that purpose. I'm just generally.
If it is wrong, then who is there to help?
I generally ask like how to fix the standard, because there should be a standard, right? Whoever is making, there should be a standard. So for that purpose only, generally I ask. I didn't ask for myself.
Google, you go around, you Google it out. There is no standard. No standard whatsoever. Each interprets in a certain way. Okay, that's where I told, please align yourself to the VC's vision. Okay, that is your immediate job. Okay, where you use the world in a certain way. Okay, so you think is the
hello, sir?
No voice is not,
sir. I think no voice,
network issue.
I think, yeah, network issue.
Network issue, maybe.
Then, like, I think until sir is coming, like Gokul sir, we in a Jain University, we having a privileges to get amend the syllabus. Usually in a big university, as an assistant professor or associate professor, even university is not giving opportunity to give his or her input also. All professors and rest buddies only working on that. So somehow, as a newbie, we having problems also.
Sir, that also nowadays it's a problem because what I'm saying is we are not getting in a proper syllabus content. So even like students are asking why still you people are teaching basics, because that things and all should come from SME or HO. So that's what my perspective.
So that we can change, sir, that wherever we feel like, for example, for my subject here, I felt that there was a need for motion graphics to come in there. But they are teaching After Effects, whereas After Effects is one of the core tools for teaching motion graphics, whereas motion graphics only is not there. So I spoke to them and I got and I introduced motion graphics for this this semester. Even for the third and the fourth semester syllabus that we created for 2020, there are a lot of topics which I changed over there, and I took the permission, ma'am, I'm changing these topics because you are saying that you are teaching advanced, but there's nothing called advanced over there. So you have that option, sir. We can go ahead and do it. Because like things are changing, I'll tell you, there are a lot of new nodes which have come out in Nuke, and people are going through all of that. But it was not there only in the syllabus. Okay, there is only one vague term called advanced compositing. Now, when we talk about advanced compositing, what are the items in the advanced in-depth compositing? Are kya hai in-depth mein? you know, it's not properly given. So it becomes very vague and it is left to the teacher how they want to teach. So I purposely went in and I put on, depth generator, and I put on these terms, you know, depth generator and relight and all of that, wherein the students also get to know that, you know, yes, these are the nodes, because when they are, they will also go out and they will Google out, these are the nodes which are being used in the industry. At least those terminologies will help them. And then they will not feel that you're teaching very basics. Because ultimately, if you have to teach them on software, it will be from the basic only.
And it's again Gokul graduation sir, only.
Gokul sir, master. I want to put a word. So at least you're asking that, okay, some changes to be done in the syllabus. But we are getting the information stating that why we should do it. HO is there now. Let HO only do the syllabus and do the format, everything. Why we have to do. That is the information we are getting. So what we should.
No. See, ma'am. See, I think everyone has misunderstood my point, because I said if you wanted some kind of a good standard, and so those who know better, so they should create all these things, and then they will share with the faculty.
That is only what we tell that because before.
I think all are misunderstood my point.
No, sir. Before we do it or something, we ask the faculty, because they take the subject now. They'll be knowing whether any changes to be made in that or what additional to be added or something. But they take it in a different way that why we should do everything, what for SMEs are there, what for head office people are there. In that way, we get the information. That's why it become ulta. Like we do and send it, then faculties will tell it has not been told us only to do it. And we wanted to add, but syllabus is not up to that level. And all these things. So who is correct, who is wrong and all these things.
I understood the mind.
Dinesh sir is there?
Sir is a network issue. He will be joined. He asked us to continue. Continue.
Okay. So in course objectives, what I've written is, so I hope the basic thing of the course objective and course outcome is clear. Now what I have written, I'll just read it out so that you can understand in context to this particular, subject. So in context to compositing techniques to interpret the objectives with which the teacher needs to teach this particular subject is to interpret compositing and video editing techniques, formulate the ways of seamless integration of matte paintings, live action and CGI footages using any compositing package, then demonstrate a complete output with color grading and sound effects. So this is the objectives of this course. Now, when we come to outcomes, now what I have done to make...
I'm so sorry. I think there was a disconnect.
Yes, sir. Hello. Sir,
I'm so sorry.
Sir, we can't hear you.
Sir, again, your voice is breaking.
Yeah. So now I'm using this thing, 4G connection.
Okay.
It will take some time for me to the backup.
Now it's clear, sir.
Yeah, it'll take a minute. Okay, you continue, Rini. I will join. Just a
all right. So that was the course.
I have one doubt in this.
Yes,
the
yes,
course
sir.
Objectives you have given three. There is like any mandatory, like only three we need to.
No. Minimum three, ma'am. If you can, right now they are saying three. I think in Abhishek sir has given five course objectives. So it's 4 to 5, right, Bhavna ma'am? If I'm not mistaken.
No. That day, Nachapa sir told we have to give only three.
But
previously we will give half five.
Five.
So,
yes.
No,
actually,
recently,
ma'am,
told three. We have to
three.
Give.
Actually, to be honest, when we had the VCs meeting, Bhavna ma'am, you were not there. Me and Amin sir from BCA and I had represented all the three departments. And Nachapa sir, when we had met VC sir, that time the other School of Engineering and all of them, they were also giving them, and everybody had this course objective of only three. There was a pattern which was followed commonly across all, and there is VC sir saying, Q3 sabka 3 Q hai. I mean, why is it three for all? You know, why some courses cannot have four, while some courses cannot have, three minimum hona chahiye, but why it cannot be more? So I think we can have four or five.
Madam, in one meeting basis, VC sir clearly said, I believe I heard that once he said minimum three. He pronounced it.
Exactly.
He pronounced it minimum.
Yes,
we have five.
There's no restrictions like that. Because I have, in all my papers, I have given five.
Yes.
Even,
sir,
even, He also showed the sample of five only.
Five only. In his CO and PO, the webinar that he took, he had shown five only.
Five and 12 he showed.
Yes.
So can
yes.
we prepare a course objectives and course outcome as per the module? Like suppose five modules are there,
yes,
each module one outcome, one objective?
Yeah, that is something.
Yes.
That okay. I think we are going into a herd mentality here. So, so be practical about it. Whether you are condensing it into only one objective where all the five modules are covered, or you are putting in three objectives, all the five modules covered. I think ideally, each module should have an objective and an outcome. Okay. So certain modules, if they the importance of the content within that module is higher, then it can have two more further objectives within that.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
but
yes.
ideally, if each module should have one objective and one outcome. Okay. When it comes to outcome, it will be very general in approach. But when it comes to, I do not comment on other verticals or other programs how they do. But ours is very unique because we can get into higher order thinking in terms of create. You understand? Mm-hmm. When I call for an assignment, okay, either I can say this is the assignment you have to do, that will be apply. Okay, that would be in the Bloom's Taxonomy level 3 apply. Or you can say it is your choice, Bulke, like you are doing a vehicle as a model. Okay, mm-hmm. You say any vehicle or any vehicle that is not there, okay, that you are doing it out of your own imagination, if it is a modeling, that would be a high order thinking of create, because you are designing your own vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
So tomorrow when it comes to assessment also, okay, either you help them and direct them in a certain way. If he is having a low order thinking, you tell the student, you do this, because he doesn't have any idea what to do. So when you direct them to your particular goal, you say that's a low order. He is able to understand whatever I've taught him and he's applying it. I have told him where it has to be applied. That's how he's applying it. Okay. Mm-hmm. Or if he says, okay, he's a very good modeler and a very good designer also. Okay. And he can independently come out with his own ideation and modeling. Okay. Then it goes into the area of create, highest order. Okay. This is not applicable in engineering. Or for that matter, marketing or any of this, because they have a set templates where you don't create or do something fantastically different, because that's a very set processes they have. Okay. If you have to say something I have created in engineering, Boletu, you have to engineer a product. You understand? In engineering, mechanical engineering stream, you have created something, Boletu, it's of very highest order. Okay. Maybe that is not possible in the university setup. But ours is a field of media and entertainment and art, you understand, where they can come out with independent ideation. So you can mark up and mark down in terms of what you give as assignments, okay, based on the student capability. So when it comes to a UG program and a PG program, okay, in a PG program, they will again learn the nuances of animation, but it should be of higher order. Are we clear about this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There are similar courses there, but here we expect the student to deliver a high order thinking. Okay. If it's very generic in approach in terms of in UG, where they are given simple tasks. Okay. When it comes to PG, they have to be given a higher order thinking task. That's what segregates. Okay. A modeling done by a UG student, a modeling done by a PG student should be remarkably different in terms of the approach. Are we clear? So these are the nuances. Usually what we do is the low order first three levels we use for UG and other three levels we use for PG. By default for any program, any vertical. You understand? When we say Bloom's Taxonomy, okay. Can I share the screen here?
Yes, yes, sir. 1 minute. I'll stop sharing. Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Just a moment. Share screen. Where is this presentation? Share. Okay. Since this discussion is happening, I thought this would be useful. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
usually I follow the same analogy. Okay, different universities have different Bloom structure in terms of they might have some words changing here and there. Okay, remember, understand, apply. Low order. Okay, for UG, predominantly when somebody comes to audit, they are looking essentially in these areas. Okay, analyze, evaluate, create. High order. Okay, but since ours is a skill-based program, okay, there is nothing called low order or high order. It is dependent on what is the complexity a student can take up. Okay, the student can create, no issue at all, he can create. When a student does his own project, his own filming project, he is creating a short film. Okay, he is not applying a short film. Okay, he is creating his own short film. Okay, but when you give a script to be shot, okay, or a certain way to be done, then it comes apply because you have done the higher order thinking as a teacher. Mm-hmm. Are we clear? When also as an assignment when you are doing, okay, this is what you do when you say this, you have to demonstrate and show me, then it is just apply only. Okay, because you have told them very clearly what needs to be done. Okay, what model or what character, what design or what texture, whatever needs to be applied, you say, okay, from the skill-based approach, this is what I want as a final outcome to judge how far you have gone, Bulke. So for that, there will be only low order in terms of apply. But if student comes out with his own independent project, when I say project, it can be an assignment also, independent assignment, then it becomes create. Are we clear about this? Any doubts so far? So,
no, sir.
It's all widely available on the Google. What kind of verbs will go where? Most of the time you will fail in the verbs. What appropriate verbs to be put in the objective? What appropriate verbs to be put in the outcomes? Okay. Objective might be holistic in approach. Okay. Understand is a very, very, student will understand, Bolito, it is a very, very vague term. Okay. Student will demonstrate is a very, very specific term. So when you are putting the verbs accordingly, okay, you can get it all downloaded in the in Google. You'll just give the Bloom's taxonomy. Okay. Use, put certain verbs. When I say remember, we call define. The student would be able to define, or he can state, yeah, he can list what it is. Okay. These are very, very, yeah, definite. Okay. Student would be able to classify. Student should be able to describe. Student will be able to explain. You understand? So we are giving a very, very specific outcomes. Okay. So don't use this verb because people more than objective, they are looking at the outcome in a very pointed way. Mm. You understand? When it comes to outcome, familiarize with the verbs. Okay. It has to be very definite in nature. Okay. What student will turn into or turn in the assignments would be a definite outcome. It cannot be a broad outcome. Okay. So look at the list of verbs that is meant for outcome and use those verbs. That is where you will get acceptance. Okay. The VC might not know, be an expert in whatever you are teaching, whatever subject knowledge you have or whatever skills you have, but definitely he will have a very clear understanding what the outcome should be. And he will catch you exactly in those verbs. Okay. Get your verbs right. Okay. Okay. Go ahead. I will stop.
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. Okay. So in the outcomes, that's why Natapa sir had shared one document where he had listed out some action verbs, which was pointed out by the VC. So in the, I took up all these verbs from there only itself. So the first one for course objectives I've taken like illustrate the basic techniques of video and audio editing, derive the various methods of 2D and 3D compositing techniques, generate motion graphics animation. So this is going on into the higher order, whereas these two go on to more or less a lower order. Then use a higher order, use chroma keying and tracking techniques for seamless integration of live action footage with CGI elements, build particle simulation, clean plates and rotoscopy footages for visual effects. So these were the outcomes, and these again, all these verbs that I have taken from that list itself, which sir had shared with us. And then I went on to map.
Some ambiguity is there in the outcomes, ma'am. That anyway, the consensus will come going forward.
Yes, sir.
Because certain people like certain verbs and certain
yes,
they don't.
Yes.
When it
yes,
comes sir. To say generate, okay, it might have a certain reaction. Okay, so yes, then you go with the flow. What is acceptable there?
Yes, okay. Yes,
but
sir. Yes.
Be very clear. It has to be very definite in our nature when it comes to
yes,
outcomes.
Yes. So if they have anything like, you know, generate, if they have an issue with that verb, then we can always change it to create, because it is ultimately creating the motion graphics animations. So creation, but then create becomes a larger thing. So that way.
Yeah. So you have to be a bit careful about this. Yes. Okay. Some people don't accept it. You cannot use create, okay, they will say. So that's where you have some 10 or 15 odd synonyms associated
correct.
With that.
Correct.
Okay.
Yes.
Next.
Then we went on to the nuances of the entire syllabus, which was there. So module one, which was on editing basics. So this here also we changed a little bit, because previously for this particular subject or course, we had two modules which were dedicated to editing. And since for my editing part, I take the help of Arun sir. Both of us, we consulted each other and we cut it down to one module on editing, and we introduced one module on motion graphics. So this was editing basics, where we took introduction to video editing and all of this. So this is there, the contents are there in the syllabus. In any case, here again, if for your particular subject that you're creating the TLP, in case you feel that you want to add certain things and certain things have become obsolete and you want to delete them, then you can do that. That sir has given us the privilege, you can do that. But along with that, what is the assessment and the activity that you are doing to assess the working of this, like whether the students have understood this or not?
Sorry for the disturbance. They can do only for third and fourth semester TLEP.
Yes.
Because it's going for BOS. Yes. Other for like fifth and sixth semester, they are taking sixth semester syllabus, they can't do.
But we can do the minor.
No, for now, this semester we can't. That I'm just telling because they might be teaching something else, then and it will be a controversy, that's why I'm just
Rini, motion graphics we have allocated in fifth semester, Rini.
No, ma'am, this fourth semester, ma'am, not fifth.
The entire one subject is there in fifth semester.
That is there, ma'am. This one I'm showing you for fourth semester, which I've done current, the even semester which we are doing. We are
No, I got it, but you were telling motion graphics is not covered in the
That was not there in this next one we have, ma'am. There I have not introduced motion graphics, ma'am. That I have taken entirely After Effects from the VFX compositing point of view. That is 2020 syllabus, ma'am.
Okay.
Then, so assessment of this we have taken, I've taken MCQ questions. So we have, now since anytime we are going offline, anytime we are going online, so MCQ questions, better to equip or train the students in the MCQ questionnaire. So assessment is MCQ. We can have quizzes. So now when we were doing offline, as in online mode, I had done a few Kahoot, using Kahoot, I had done some quizzing, which the students really enjoyed. So we introduce assessment. Okay, with the quizzing also, what happened when we did the revision classes, I did these quizzing. So it becomes easier for me also, and rough revision of the students also happens. So quiz, then descriptive questionnaire for Blue Book submission. Now this we all know, we usually give when we are in offline mode, they have to write out. So to get them experienced in that field also, like, you know, how to write, what questions to write. So the assessment can be done with descriptive questions for the Blue Book. This is basis of what the PPTs or the reading materials or the references or the notes that we are giving for this particular module.
Okay.
Then
On the assessment, Bhavana, you would like to present how you have done assessment?
Yes,
sir. I prepared rubrics, sir. I will show you.
I'll stop share.
Yes, please. Good afternoon, all. So based on Vice Chancellor presentation, assessment with rubrics, I have made very short span of time. I prepared one of our digital filmmaking subject, practical filmmaking. So here, before we are giving the assessments to the student, maybe any kind of assignments, maybe case study or research or making film, whatever it may be, what kind of assessments you are going to do. So we have to give the brief introduction, brief about the assessments to understanding the student. So here, it's a basic template I have prepared. It is course name, subject, assessment, year and all. And then this is a practical filmmaking. So I made here a declaration because they are making a film. It should be original, and then they should not copy from the internet also, plagiarism and the, so all declaration is there for the students. Then we have given certain rules and regulations for the students. The first I am giving the introductions briefing about the what is the assessment, what is the assignments for practical filmmaking. They have to make either a short film or documentary they have to make. So here I'm just giving the instruction to the students what they have to do. They have to script, storyboard, and they have to produce the film for 3 to 5 minutes. Okay, so what about the team members, everything, each team, how they have to submit their own version of the short films. Here, for example, that day VC sir also discussed, one of the faculty member from the design team also, they asked about, sir, it is a creative project, it's a group project, how we will do the rubrics. Mm-hmm. So I'm here, we identify certain way. So I'm here, I will explain you how I have done for rubric for the this group projects. And so I have given here the two topics. I have just nominated these topics I'm giving to the students. Based on this topic, they will make a film. So how they have to presentation, that is, we have given the instructions. Here, assessment criteria, it is being segregated into any kind of productions, maybe animation or gaming or filmmaking. We are having three set of pre-production, productions, and post-productions. So here in pre-productions is script writing, storyboard, and then short composition, technical aspects and all. So we have how many weeks they will do the work, what are the works, week one, what they have to submit, week two, week three, week four. And then I have given the detailed instructions to the students, how they have to do the final presentation. So here I'm coming to the point, how do I make a rubrics here? So according to this rubric assessment evaluation, first, the teacher has to first the list the evaluation criteria that we'll be assessing. So this is the rubric format. So what we have to do, first we have to create a rubric table for our assignment, whatever assessment may be. So here, this part is there, this is the evaluation criteria. Mm-hmm. This is the level of mastery, what you are going to. This evaluation criteria, it may be vary, depends upon the faculty, teachers, depends upon the subject also. Here for filmmaking, have prepared script writing, storyboard, then production is segregated into short composition, technical skills, as well as here levels of mastery also. This also, it depends upon the faculty. See here, bifurcated, advanced, established, demonstrated, some evidence related to the film and little evidence, or else there's another option is there. You can that day VC sir explain, it's a very good, excellent, and the needs to improve. That also, it depends upon the subjects, what you are creating. So it's a below standard, satisfactory, needs to improve, accomplished, excellence. I have given a 3 example here. Excellent, proficient, partially proficient, incomplete, not submitted. So this is the way we have to create. So when you are creating this rubric table for your subjects, you have to give the quality definition of the particular thing. For example, when we are meaning here advanced. So what the faculty is meaning here, what that definition you have to give. For example, here the script is imaginative, original, and shows advanced understanding of the story development. The script is correctly formatted, highly detailed, and provides a conscious, concise, practical guide to the storyboard and film. So in such case, students has done all these things, then I can give the market as advance. I will show you that how assessment. So once I created for assignment, my assignments or topic, once I created this rubric table. So when we have to distribute to the students, so they came to know what we are expecting from them, okay, from the students. Okay. So once we are distributed, when they're submitting the assignment, the exercise. So this is after that, I'm just doing the evaluation. So here I'm writing the each and every students. I'm writing here the definition, what is occurring. So whatever the works he has submitted, it is highly like no imaginative, is original. It is a strongly understand of the story development, everything. So this criteria I'm giving like no maybe maximum, if I kept a 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So I'm giving the particular area, the script writing, I'm giving 5 marks. So for example, he is not in script writing, he's just in established. I can mark it here as a 4, and then storyboard, it is very well, he's very good in storyboarding. I can mark it here, the storyboard is highly detailed, and like no, his images are correctly labeled and everything is the like no it's processed in storyboard clearly and creatively reflect according to the script. So I'm giving here is the 5 marks, it's advanced level. Or so some students is not good in storyboard, it is a storyboard is not that much good. So I'm giving that explanation here, what he has done, I'm giving as a 3, 4. So this is the format of assess according to the rubric assessment. This is the template. So first we have to create the table for our according to our assessment, like no assignments. Then once the students is submitted, we have to evaluate the individual students according to this, like no our table. We have to do this table and we have to do this rubric assessment. So it's like this. Then we have final grade and then comments and signature. So it will be say here another example here for video production. It can be vary each and every. It's like no stat satisfaction or you are accomplished or excellent. I have an example for another animation also.
Ma'am, I'll just interpret here. Yes, this one. One thing that I just wanted to clarify is this is the rubrics for the practical part, right?
So theory also, if for example theory subject 30 marks is internal, okay, it's a 10 marks internal. So for 10 marks internals, what we are doing, we are giving for one activity, that particular activity also we have to evaluate according to this rubric assessment format.
That is one activity for the whole. But here what sir, what is there in the template that they have given is that they have what I understood, what sir told me is that every module should have, whether the student has understood that module, for that you have to give one activity.
This is for practical subject taken as an example.
Correct. I understood that. I'm just clarifying this, that let's say suppose if I'm doing editing concepts, this editing also would be similar to this. That's why I'm just. Then the assessment of the theory part could be like, as you said, like could be whatever I've given, but then the activity is to create a montage. Now, when we are saying create a montage, in that the rubrics would be what you just now explained.
Yeah, yes.
Correct.
What you are giving, the teacher has to create. So first thing is we have to create the rubric table for our assessment. So what kind of exercise assignment, whatever it may be, you can do. For that, first the teacher has to create a like no table column
table
for your thing. Then accordingly, when the student submitted, we have to evaluate. So we need some like no proof. So I have given already to the student. Student has done this thing. So I'm just mapping to my table and then I'm giving the mark accordingly. So
okay. Bhanu ma'am, 1 minute. So this is for a group project also, the same kind of.
Yes, I am coming to the point.
So okay,
yes,
then
group projects.
Yeah, yes, then sir? I have one query, because suppose 4 students are in one group, they are doing one project. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Any one person is doing storyboard. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Maybe another 3 people are involving in production and post-production. Then for that, those who are not participated in that storyboard, then how we are going to give the marks?
Yeah, that's why here, like, no, when we are evaluating, we have to mention, just a minute, I will show you. So like what we have to like, no, segregate the nature of the job for the students. Then as a teacher only, you have to decide.
No, that means we may change these rubrics for each student, right?
Yes, sir.
That
yes,
rubric
sir.
Is okay. Completely for each and every student. Analysis for okay. The betterment, sir.
Yes, got it.
Now, one which he is showing is the assessment rubrics for the common, for the
common
entire
one.
Topic.
Okay.
And the other one, if they are in a group, if you are there, if even in the BCSR's meeting also,
yes,
somebody who said this.
Correct.
Then he said that for that case, the ideal would be that you prepare a separate rubric. Within that project, big rubrics, you
correct.
Prepare a separate rubrics for each of the students. Only okay. Then you will be able to get the true marks for the evaluation
okay.
of the students.
As well as same thing, sir, for individual project also. See here, teamwork. How was the teamwork? The team has to present what are the teamwork they have done. They have to submit the proof of photographs. As I have mentioned in my document also, they have to submit the photographs and then working stills and then raw footage. So many evidence they have to submit. Accordingly, we will give the marks for that, sir.
Great.
Okay, everyone here, sorry. See, going forward, the education will phenomenally transform the way it is practiced now to in the coming decade. It will be practiced widely in a variant manner. Okay. Where typically how I visualize is the classroom would be a kind of a flipped classroom where their homework will become classwork and classwork will become homework. So your lectures, everything would get pre-recorded, or they have to go through a certain set of lecture. Okay, before they come and attend the class. In the class, they would be sitting and doing the assignments. Okay, either their individual assignments or their group assignments. So the classroom might no longer be a particular way, how it is facing the board and all that. It might be a collaborative effort where some five people are put together and the teacher would be spending more time with individual groups or individuals. So rather than lecturing. Okay, this is how the things will work out going forward. Now, why these rubrics in terms of assessment? Well, all these years, if you look at our education quality, okay, nobody bothered what happens to the student once he goes to the industry. How far is this knowledge fetching for him? Usually what's happening with the traditional degrees, this knowledge gets consumed in 2 or 3 months, that's all. Whatever they have done the study for 15, 16, 17, 18, whatever years they would have invested in learning, all this learning will go out of the door within 3 months to 6 months. Okay, they have to unlearn and relearn actually. So that's what is happening currently. So that's a big cause of concern in the education community. Are we there on the right page? So this assessment rubrics, when we go through, okay, what the other day the VC was telling, like after 3 or 4 years, they again go and look at the student practicing in industry. See where they are and how far this education has helped them. Okay. And if that student comes back and says, okay, these are the things that was that would have been extremely helpful for me, or these are the things that was quite unnecessary, I'm not using anymore in my practice, they can come and revisit exactly and make changes. Okay. So this assessment rubrics was not there at all, not much. Okay, maybe at the end of it, the alumni would be called and asked to give some advice to the Board of Studies if what further development can happen. And there was no transparency in how effectively it was implemented. Now, there are quite a lot of issues also, like how my faculties are getting trained in the advanced technologies also. Okay, if you say, okay, these are the some substance painters there, that is widely practiced. Okay, now my academic, who is delivering the, he is not used to substance painter, there is a handicap. Okay, you can easily say, okay, yes, there is a handicap in terms of substance painter not getting taught. But so that is where again they're enmeshing the what kind of FTPs we can have, okay, over this, for that particular. So now whatever priority they are giving students in terms of tailoring, tailor-made approach, that tailor-made approach will come back to the faculty also in terms of what areas he can improve. Are we clear about this? So it's a cycle that is beneficial in the long run. No. But yes, practically, it is a new animal for they do not know how to handle this. Okay. More accountability you bring in the system, more uncomfortable people feel. Okay. Because it might feel that somebody is intruding in your personal space. Okay. Myra teaching, they are monitoring very closely. Or am I under the eyes or radar of most of the time? These are the questions that comes. Yes, accountability going forward is very important, because when information is available in Google and YouTube, okay, the role of a teacher will drastically change going forward. Okay, so we have to reinvent ourselves. Okay, accountability will be there, whether we like it or not. Today, after I finish my work, okay, some 2 decades before, if I finish my work, go home, that's it. My employer will not be able to contact me. Okay. But today, if you see, even at 12 o'clock, he can just pick a message and ask what is the update here or what update. That's the kind of connected world we are living in. Okay. when it comes to this, yes, there is lot of things coming under scanner, okay, how we are delivering. And all this, yes, I was facing any of these audits, any of this, none of the academics knew how to go out with the programs. Okay, so they will just restrict to certain formalities in terms of auditing and be off. Okay, but in that, of course, they know that they are not trained in this particular area to do the assessment. Okay. So most of the time when I open viewers also, I used to ask how many of you have industry experience or any experience in the media industry. That was my opening statement in any of the viewers. And I asked them to raise the hand. None of the hands used to get raised. And I used to invite some careful industry person to validate and go forward and make it a useful process. So it is very, very essential for you to get through this. Okay. Yes, it is a pain most of the time when you sit into this, and you might have many variants coming in. Okay. Every other day, the format might get changed. Okay. Because they want to bring a kind of commonality that would be acceptable. Okay. So be prepared for what you call it as a thing, nature of this whole process. It will take another year or two to settle down. Okay. So we cannot do much about it because that is the vision of that particular university. Okay. Carry on.
Okay. Here some of the online tools, like, you know, I have mentioned here, this is the online tools which is available. It's like, you know, for example, for your art departments, any which is relevant to your subjects, if you find it, like, if you want to get some an idea, some of the tools are real. It's available. You can create rubrics also, assessment. You can give the topic or, like, you know, particular kind of assignments that it will create. It will give. Some of the online tools are paid versions. A few is like, you know, trial and free versions also. If you want, you can try also, like, you know, for example, creating a definitions and how I bifurcate the rubrics for my particular assignments and all. There is like a lot of few online tools are available there. You can try it. So for creating this rubric, first thing is we have to like, you know, create how, what kind of, like, you know, assessment, and then what kind of activity we are going to give, that we have to identify and evaluate the criteria that you will be going to assessing. Then the second one, we have to, like, you know, create the level of mastery. I said, no, this level of mastery is here, like, you know, advanced or established. It's like, you know, it's according to the Bloom taxonomies, even vocabulary verbs, you can use it. So here, like, you know, what, how we are going to evaluate your assignments, that, like, you know, this level of mastery you have to identify first. Then it is like, you know, higher order or lower order. For our example, external, excellent, like good and moderate and all. Here, why I mentioned here, some of in our CA, some of the students, they won't submit the particular assignments also, the particular thing. So for that reason, like, no, I mentioned here, it's not submitted also. If they're not submitted anything, we will mark it as zero. So poor we can give. So likewise, the next, like, no, write a quality definition of each level of mastery. So when we are creating a table, each and everything according to our assignments, our activity, we have to, as a teacher, we have to create. See here, and this evaluation criteria I have given as a script writing. Here I have to define that what I'm expecting from the student.
As a teacher,
scripters. So as a, like, no, like what the particular like, no, particular department pre-production work, what student has to do, how it should be. So I'm just, what I'm as a teacher, we have to mention here. So it's all criteria, like, no, it's all higher order, we have to mention the same thing. The next thing is then rubric table for evaluation. So we have to, after created this, after we collected all the assignments from the students, so each and every students we have to create. That's what the new method of evaluation, like, no, now the university is like, no, like giving instructions to us as a faculty, because for the betterment of the students' improvement. So this rubric table, it will tell each and every student the particular assignments. We can, like, no, this student, you have done this such a work, you have to, needs to improve. What is the, like, no, usually what we will do, we just see the output, we will just bifurcate, we will give. That's it. We are not pinpointing what mistakes they have done. What is the, like, no, what they are, what is lagging over there, what they have to need to improve and all. So here, according to the previous rubrics table which we created, no, so we are referring the table. We are already, before, while we are giving the assignment to the students, we have to give this table also. this is the criteria. You have to, according to the criteria, you have to submit the assignments. So once they submit it, we have to evaluate, we have to write it here, like, you know, what are the work students has done. So accordingly, finally, we will mark it as mark here out of this, out of 20 marks or 30 marks. So whatever, it's maybe it's activity you are giving for 10 marks activity, what you have to give, like, no, maybe like, for example, advanced level, you can keep it. Now 8 to 10, those who are secured, 8 to 10, you can give it here is advanced. So like, no, 5 to 7 is established. So then there may be 3 to 4, it's a moderate. Likewise, so how you will give a Likert scale of, like, no, rating, the same way you have to give the you as a teacher has to, like, no, assign here the rating for the each and every category. Here we have to evaluate the student's assignment. This is like, no, rubric method of evaluation, students assignment as a evaluation.
Okay, here I want to add, most of time the student feedback is very critical. Okay, if a student start hating a teacher or whatsoever reason, okay, he can simply raise a complaint, and everyone takes it very seriously. Okay, this teacher is very bad, and she has not taught properly, she did not come on time, she did not give assignments, she did not evaluate my assignments, whatever crap. You don't have a shred of evidence the way currently what you're practicing to defend yourself. Clear? Okay. So then they just want to, then two or three troublemakers can really bunch together, get some more support, and they will turn against you. Understand? So when you have everything structured, okay, this we will try to automate as much as possible. Okay, going forward, it might be one of our objectives of a Kraken team to automate this so that you don't have to do much of paperwork. It will be your regular evaluation, and this should be ideally be automated so that when you pick up your assignment to evaluate, automatically all these parameters come to you. So you just keep ticking, marking, putting comment, and be done with it. Yes. Okay, like that, when you do, you have a timestamp over it. Well, I have done, I have instructed. So they can look at your instruction material in terms of whatever videos you are presenting. You are accountable. Nobody can have any dispute over it that this class has not been done. Then when you are doing this assessment, then you will know that certain students who are troublemakers would never fit into this, any of this category. Clear? Okay. So more than it as a chore, you think this is a very good insurance against any of the developments against you. It might be a pain now, okay, but going forward, this is what will protect. And when you go present, not only here, anywhere, wherever you go for employment, when you have such documentation, you are taken very seriously. You understand? We had a choice of doing it or not doing it in KL University. Okay, while the other departments, they refused to do. We had our own IT vertical in KL University. They did not conform to those requirements. But in the head office, we took it as a challenge, and we told we will do it just for the sake that, yes, that is a good learning. We saw a huge potential coming in. Maybe it was too detail oriented and too much of paperwork in it, but that would be a good blueprint how you deliver and how you are accountable for that delivery. And there will be no dispute whatsoever. Okay. And even a person who comes from non-discipline specific background to come and audit, when you have a detailed document like it, they back off. They appreciate and they back off. Mm-hmm. Clear? Okay. It is not convincing who already know about it. Those who are from different background, when they come and when you are able to convince them adequately, that is where you make a huge difference. Okay. That is where we can bring uniformity in the creative education space. Okay, because AI subjective hai, ye objective nahi hai. Like that, this is the general distinction. Sir, it is not like programming and all that. 2 + 2 is not 4. Oh, yeah. Like that, a lot of arguments come. Here it is creativity, sir. Low. Yes. How you measure the creativity? What is the rubric here? Yes, there is a document out there. Yes. And you do it. And tomorrow, any dispute arises whatsoever, you can revisit the document and say, well, this I had given him assignment on so-and-so date. And I had given this thing. So many people submitted on time. And this was the assessment I gave. And this student failed to do this. So any success would be, according to me, would be a step-by-step process. Any failure is also a step-by-step process. When you have a troublemaker, it will be a failure process. And these are the checks and balances that will help you immensely in your delivery. okay, because the technology will take the other part of it. You can deliver a lecture when you are free, but mind is totally focused, and you can deliver, you can record the lecture, you can play it. Nobody can deny it. Are we clear? Okay, that at the same time you can sit with that and do the assessment also with the student sitting, whatever assignment he is doing. So technology is a great enabler. You should know how to usefully take it forward. Okay, and can you stop sharing the screen, ma? I want to show her.
Yes, sir. Sir, one thing, sir, here, Gopal, sir, you asked, no, sir, like group projects. See, I have given a description to my students. They work together, assignments to create a video project. These are the things, sir. The presentation should include appropriate photographs, video, music, graphs, all the visualize. What are the works they are doing, sir? So for that also, I have given clearly.
Okay, okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Ma'am, I think once this is done, you can share the rubrics one also with everyone so that they can have an idea, like the way I shared the outcome. And the...
Yes, ma'am. This is just roughly that. It's prepared, ma'am. It's afternoon only I got to know. Then
no problem. Okay. You finish that and...
For me, workshop involves everyone having taken it. Okay. You learn from each other. Okay. Rather than me going on a boring discussion. Okay. This is how we have to be done. Rather, it will be a collaborative effort. Okay. Each one comes with certain strength. Okay. In terms of what they can and they cannot. So utilize each other's strength. Okay. That's where the interaction would be great. And you will start trusting each other. Now, is my screen clear?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Visible? Yes, sir. Okay.
Yes.
Actually, we had went to this extent in KL, okay, where how you deliver a lecture is also very systematic and structured in its approach. Okay, I will not recommend now. Maybe this is what the VC is looking forward when he says, okay, I want to see something spectacular happening. This is what you can do. Okay, if you are delivering a lecture, say typically you have 1.5 hours lecture or whatever it is, 2 hours, segregate it every 10 minutes. This is the introduction I'm giving. Tomorrow you might get into e-learning jobs or some remote online universities. Whatever you do, this would be highly helpful for you. Okay, how do I structure my delivery? Okay, if it is whether I'm demonstrating or whether I'm delivering a lecture, what I would cover, or what would be the introduction I would give, how much time I will take, how much time I will dwell on the topic. Okay, what all additional notes I will give, what all interaction I have with the students. So this is what you do on day in and day out. When you go and deliver a party, it is nothing new. Only thing is, yes, we are bringing a structure in it. When you start putting it together, you get into that kind of discipline. Okay, some lectures might be for 6 hours or 8 hours when you demonstrate certain this thing. So it is all the more essential to have a good flow so that whomsoever comes to audit at whatever point of time, this is what I do in my classroom. This is what is getting delivered. Okay, so that would be a very good blueprint of how we approach towards a very organized and systematic and structured living for ourselves. Okay, most of the time we get into trouble because we are unable to manage our time. Okay, whatsoever reason. Okay, it might be a disturbance from the student or any of this. So you can say, look, you might have a delivery for 60 hours, wherein effectively you'll be delivering for 40, 45 hours. Okay, a particular course would be assigned for some 60 hours, but due to whatsoever practical issues, you might be ending up delivering for 40 hours only. Okay, so when you have this content structured in this particular way of delivery, you know exactly what they might miss out if they, and even if student or a parent comes back and he says, this is how I plan and this is how we deliver, and your student chose, now your son's or daughter chose not to come and attend this session, naturally, there is a disconnect in the subsequent session. Clear? So that's how they are failing going forward. So one, the discipline will inculcate what they have missed out. Tomorrow, if in the result analysis, they say why the student failed. Well, he did not attend this session. And the final assessment happened on this. This was the continuous assessment we had. This was the internal assessment we had. And this was the final examination we had. Well, he missed out all this. Okay. That's how. So when you have a meeting with the parent or with any stakeholder, this will help you immensely in telling exactly where the problem is. Okay. So don't think it is we are doing a favor on each other by getting into these details. Yes, This is there to protect you. And also you will get disciplined and structured in a certain way. That scaffolding will help you in a big way going forward. Okay. So, yeah, you have any further items to discuss, we can be regarding this. Please go ahead. Anybody having any reservations on this?
Sir, even this TLP, no, even my previous organization, I have done also. One here, physical challenges, what we are facing here. When everything is set in classroom, then we will go and then 10 minutes we will give introduction, 30 minutes, all it is according to our blueprint, what we have. But here physically, when you are going to the classroom, then that time only we are finding like, no, we came to know there is no projector, so many physical challenges we are facing in that at our atmospheres are there in university.
Automation helps, ma. You record your lecture, you record your demonstration, even whatsoever reason it misses out. Okay, your demonstration, your lecture is ready. Okay, so you can work. See, at the end of it, today people don't use technology anyway. We are all comfortable with the tradition. Last 5,000 years, the classroom has not changed. There will be one teacher with 20 students, and this is how the interaction happens. Okay, and the teacher will act like a god, and he will start conveying the kind of knowledge. No, things have changed. Okay, adapt to those requirements, and there will be very slow learners also. They need repeatedly. They need to be advised about a particular way. If you find typically you give a modeling or a texturing or any of this, you'll find some 40 to 50% of the class failing at pick up that particular skill at that particular point of time. Okay, so when you do assessment, you will see a pattern happening. Okay, this is where they are failing, so that you can reinforce in terms of giving additional information. Today nobody does a post analysis. Okay, the top scorer would be 80% and the bottom feeder would be around 35%. So that 20% knowledge is not getting conveyed whatsoever way. Okay, the failure also fails in that, and the topper also fails to understand that. Okay, so when you have this kind of assessments in place, you know exactly why the people are failing, why they are not picking up those skills there. So next time when you are creating content, you will be focused more on that. That is where the intelligence comes in. Okay, if they are failing to pick up a particular tool or a particular technique in, say, in compositing or something like that, and that is very tricky. Say your hair is flying around and you have to pick up in a certain way against the green screen. Okay, when you do the roto. So you know this is where exactly people will make mistakes, because we are from the production background. Okay, instead of going gung-ho and putting the entire demonstration for 3 hours, 5 hours, record it, you can just focus on that particular part where they fail more and give more attention to it.
No, sir, actually,
and you can say this is where the students are failing. When you are teaching also, they say, look, you can be playful, but here you focus more. You will fail here, because tomorrow when you are going and taking a test in a studio, they are exactly assessing this particular parameter. Okay, that's how your candidature might be rejected in a test. So you better focus here and you get these things right here. So when we do this, it becomes a kind of personalized teaching. How many of us do the result analysis and say why people are not picking up a particular skill or particular knowledge they are not able to recollect? Because we don't do that and we don't emphasize on it. Maybe subconsciously we might be doing, but it is not a focused approach towards it. Okay. So yes, these are things that will help you in a big way.
No, sir, I agree your assessment point, sir. What is my point of your question is here. See, this TLP, it is like no new template that 10 minutes for introduction, 30 minutes for brief descriptions and all. So as a teacher, I prepared this TLP. So when I'm going to the physical classroom, it is not like actual real, realistic situation was totally different. For example, if I'm going to the classroom, that time only I came to know the projector is not working. So I'm just sorting out the issue. It is some technicality issues was there and the infrastructure. So that situation, how can I adapt this TLP, genuinely in the realistic world?
It can be challenges. You can come back because this TLP will be readily available to you. This 10 minutes I wasted in taking attendance. Okay, 10-15 minutes I took attendance, I wasted on it. So please automate it. My effort is going in a wasted exercise called taking attendance, where I have to go through all these 50 students for 10 next to 15 minutes. So as a university, you find a solution for this. So I don't do this. Point number one. Point number two, sir, I have delivered this lecture for last 20 hours. For in that 20 hours, I spent some 5 hours fixing the the project. Okay, so I this is what I have done. So see, everything you can. We are from a drama company, right? We create stories, we create dramatics, right? Okay, that drama will be very effective when you come out with this certain data points. When you highlight this, these are the issues, sir. I was actually searching for the classroom because the classroom was not.
We had an
along
experience.
With me, the students were running here
morning
and
morning only we came to know where is our classroom.
Okay, so that 15 minutes, sir, in the TLP I had planned like this, but 15 minutes I was roaming to identify the classroom, sir. Next 10 minutes I fixed the projector, sir, issue. Then I took the class, sir. So I had to compromise on next 30 minutes. This is how you can go and pinpoint, and for which they don't have any answers. They have to again find a solution. We don't have proof of evidence on any of this. Okay, so but when you evidently put it across and prominently, this is what. So some point of time people will reflect. They have to reflect. It's up to them. Everyone has a conscience, man. Nobody's a robot out there. Everyone has a conscience, and it is being pointed in a certain way. Okay, you can be very cool about it. You need not be angry, upset, or any of this, sir. This is the TLP for the week. Okay, this is how the time was wasted. This is what I had planned. Against the plan, this was the implementation. End of the story. Because yes, I have seen enough of the parent-teacher meeting. I have seen enough of this result analysis. I have seen enough of this BOSs. Based on the experience, yes, what we lack is valid proof. And this documentation would be valid proof where things are going wrong very seriously. It is up to them to take or not to take it seriously. But it can be highlighted and put across rather than writing a list of points and say, yeah, there's you just see the kind of queries we have raised with the Jain universities that, sir, we don't have a classroom. We are adjusting. Okay, what big deal? Please adjust. That's all. No, sir, this is getting affected because of this. And this is the outcome. And because of this, I will not be able to skill the student in this particular area. So that way, accountability can be all around. Okay, right, ma'am. Any further?
Sir, I just like to point out the decision plan, session wise teaching.
Who is this?
Arun, sir. Arun.
Arun, yeah.
Arun, sir.
Yeah. So, this actually, we were actually practicing around 2 years back when KL University, we were actually teaching in that particular part. So one advantage I could see, because I also had created this particular session wise plan. Is you know, we can actually plan out you know, the entire semester teaching with this one document. Like, for example, 60 hours teaching means we can initially only we can plan out, like, you know, this 60 hours how we are going to plan out. So it will become very less headache for us also as a teacher, so that you know, we have planned it out before itself, hand itself, so we can go you know, step by step to reach to that particular goal. So this actually
Arun, sir, anyway, past semester we are following the same, like we are actually doing the weekly classroom plan. So
yes.
Weekly wise also we can develop instead of doing everyday session. So yeah. Weekly wise also, I mean, previous week itself we can prepare for the next week how
next
we
week.
Did yeah. How we did last semester. Same thing also. It is possible,
yes,
right?
Last semester also we had something called the course plan. That was also something like this, only session wise. But I think this is like every time, like, you know, 10 minutes, 30 minutes like that. There also we had this course plan, which was quite an elaborate and a very good document, which I thought that the university had come up with. But then again, this semester they came up with that session plan, which I don't think is as good as what we had earlier.
Yes.
Ma'am, anyway, finally, see, we can't blame. There is no infra, there is no materials, because past
we
7-8 months.
The work.
No. Past 8 months, we are teaching through online. Even no students are bothered about infra and projector, all these things. So, same way, anyway, we have all the content in our laptop. If the projector is there, we can keep the laptop and we can show from whatever the sources are available.
हाँ सर, लेकिन जैसे fortunately for I think you guys must be facing the issue MSCs, because fortunately for animation we don't have so much of classroom issue, but for DFM and for MSC you guys have been running around for classroom. When I used to take DFM also, it used to be like that.
I used to stand in front of the class, the other class they have to complete, then immediately.
It is a different discipline. It's a different. It's not our, like, it's not Rini taking an animation class who will come out and give it to Bhavna. It's like a different. A whole other people who don't even know us, and they take their own sweet time and they say yes we are coming, and then ye karne mein 5-10-15 minutes aram se goes in that. Then another 5 minutes for the students to settle down, then another 5 minutes to take attendance. Aise karte karte half the class is gone only.
We used to stand outside, sir, then student and faculty also, then we get in. That's why I'm just asked, sir. It's planning, it's good. Even, sir, I told, sir, like, nearly 5 to 6 years, the previous administration I have practiced. But there, everything is settled down. So the teacher has to go to class and then they will take, then it's real. Like, no, it will work it out. That's why I just... just discuss with sir, like, if it is when we practice, then actual reality it is, we are finding it a little more difficult. That sir also given a solution, we can note it on there. Because of this reason I couldn't able to follow up this, it might be noted.
See, we have been through to so many audits, okay, and the shouting slanging matches used to happen, and I used to feel really upset and bad about it, and all this what I thought was would a kind of insurance against all this.
Yes, sir, definitely.
So, anyways, any other further queries, ma'am, please?
Sir, is there any planning for animation department in JNU University to get a start the PhD enrollment in upcoming semesters?
Who is this?
Abhishek here.
Abhishek, yeah. So we are going. Frankly, I'm establishing media schools. Okay, that was the vision behind this. It is very easy for people to say, oh, this is not right, that is not right. But if you look at 7 years back, the acceptance of animation as a long-term program was a big question mark. Okay, so everywhere we have to really fight it out and find some accommodation. That's how we could get accommodated under the IT. I'll be clear. Okay, and the students' parents' mentality was such that there was a huge acceptance issue back then. Now, in last 3-4 years, things have changed drastically. We are looking at having dedicated departments. Okay, but UGC, AICT are all very much confused. How do I place this? Still, some disputes keep happening. Whether it should be called BSc or should be called BFA, it should be called BA, or it should be called BWOC. What not? You name it, I have it. Okay. So in all this, yes, and the UGC have to lay a proper guideline, because ours is a $45 billion industry. Nobody can ignore it, and millions of people work in our industry, and still the government has not recognized. And many a times, I still remember having a dispute with the education secretary in Haryana when I was visiting the North Cap University. So literally we had to fight to make the BFA program in animation and visual effects. What I had done there was BFA animation and visual effects, what I had given. So I had to fight with that education secretary, okay, for close to 45 minutes, okay, to get it accepted as a BFA. And we finally accepted with a, brackets here and there. You call BFA and you put it in bracket animation and visual effects. For that, a IAS officer or something like a team of 3 or 4 IAS officers are sitting, okay, trying to come with a conclusion. Finally, they gave me a solution of putting a bracket around it. So this is the kind of funny experience, which the kind of what you call as vagueness that we have in the education industry. Still, we went ahead, because for me, this is very essential for us to have a very robust media environment in India. Okay, the skilling is very important and the acceptability is very important. So yes, there is always a challenge, but going forward, you will find many media departments getting set up, because someone has to take the pain. Well, from the industry perspective, I have done my job. So before I go back to the industry. So any further questions?
So I think, sir, my question was either we are going to start PhD or not, sir.
Yes, PhD is a mandated going forward. Okay, because UGs have mandated that for UG and PG, we should have essentially, that's how we have started hiring PhDs. Okay, so
sir is asking like now whether we are going to start PhD program
in it depends on the university.
In the J University, we are planning. Okay, again, they have to get absolute clarity how the school would be, because first we have to identify ourselves as a separate school. Are we clear? As a media school or as a media, as a separate department, as a separate school. Okay. Only when it happens, because under the IT, we have certain constraints going forward, because they will again cap it with the IT requirements. I still remember we did a BCA VFX program where they forced us to have first 3 semester, the VFA, IT content, BCA. BCA, IT content, they forced me. Next 3 semesters, I have to operate and take it out. So same way when it comes to having a separate department in terms of you guiding, or for that matter anybody guiding, yes, there is a thought process. Again, it takes its own sweet time. Well, it is there in the process. And in Srinivasa, we have established there is a certain faculties are pursuing there. They know the importance of it. Same way in certain pockets, they have started. Well, you can be a pioneer and go ahead and propose. Thinking, let's see how it goes. Shapes up.
Because, sir, yeah, you are totally right. Several people having confusion about animation, either it's a BFA or BA or mass communication. But meanwhile, in last 1.5 year back, we have a meeting in a UGC team member. So finally, they had accommodated animation as in a computer science engineering. And fortunately, one of my friends, Samir, in IIT Bombay, so he has also accommodated animation in the computer science engineering. So if Pioneer, India's two top-notch institutions kept this one thing in engineering and computer science, then I think now as an vertical head, you or we are a suggestive teacher, we can push animation at least as in a part of CSIT, and we can even offer PhD in computer science engineering, a specialization animations also. This could be possible. So my feeling, VIT has also started BTech and MTech, I think, in computer science, specialization game technology, and in specialization multimedia and animation. Maybe Bhavana ma'am having idea, because she is a graduate of VIT itself. So definitely, sir, that would be a really very big thing for us. And second one thing, as per a business perspective also, if we are looking right now in India, no one is specifically offering a design animation related PhD in a private university. So this would be the one of the big USP for us in a JNU university if we are taking initiative these things.
Yes, it definitely does. But again, you have to look at the business part of it, when they do what they do. Okay, however holistically or whatever and the socially committed they are, okay, there is a business angle to it. Okay, how many enrollments will happen, how much revenue will be generated, how viable it is. Okay, so everything boils down to this. So rather I would go the other way around, say, look, here I have 10 PG students or 10 people who are from the PG background, I am going to guide them. Now you find a way, they will find a way. You understand? That's how I have rammed it most of the time. Okay.
Sir, I think Abhishek, sir, he is having 10 students, so he wants to get.
Yeah, just go ahead and this is the revenue. This is the revenue the university will generate by the exercise. So then you will find ways and means of getting things done. So this I will keep it offline. I did not tell you all this. But yes, unofficially, I will tell this how it works, because we live in a capitalistic society. Okay, in the capitalistic society, nothing comes free. Okay. सब बड़े बड़े बातें होता है, लेकिन जो होता है जो होता है. You understand? So we have not just, we don't have some 900 odd universities like private universities, 600 universities just like that. Okay, doing social service. So it all comes to the how good it is physically, financially, how viable it is. Okay, it cannot be a one-off affair, because you can start anything in India now, but you cannot shut down easily.
Right.
The other day, somebody was telling, okay, I will put you in some board of director and all that. I told, look, don't do that. Because opening a company is very easy in India. Now you go ahead and close the company, it will take 2 years.
Challenge.
So those are the challenges that we face both in education and in industry. Okay. To you can start the initiative, but the second part of it is very sustainability, and taking it forward is a big challenge. And they are also very much afraid, okay, what if Abhishek leaves? You understand? Mm-hmm. Then we will be left with some 9 students wondering what to do next. Okay, so they also look at the risk averse about all this, and they don't want to be held a ransom for any of this, so they should have sufficient backups who will do what. Okay,
right.
So it can be just he leaving or something happening wherein he cannot contribute. So there is issues. Okay, from our perspective, we look at opportunity. From their perspective, they look at sustainability and growth and taking it forward. So if you have all the answers, then there should not be anything much holding back us back in terms of pushing this initiative.
Right.
Okay. Next. Any further questions, queries? Okay, guys, it has been a very long session. So I don't believe in, I thought I would keep it as vibrant as possible. Again, it went into monologues. Okay. But these initiatives, I do not know how many OBEs you are subjected to so far, but everything should be practically viable. That's why I try to keep it as close to our subjects, not trying to present what is widely available. So what is pertinent to us, we are trying to explore and make it just journey easier. And Kraken as a platform is doing a OBE training, okay, that will help you out in doing this kind of documentation. So Mamta and Ajay will facilitate this initiative, okay. So Ajay, you would like to add something to this, or Mamta? Hey guys, so, are you there? Yeah.
No, so I think we have a demo session for OBE in from Kraken team. Once it has been done, I think we can have interaction with the faculty. So.
And when you have this interaction, no, we very, very specific what you want, okay? And write to them, marking us. This is what we exactly want from you, okay? Because development nahi hota hai, automation nahi hota hai, then you will come back and say, sir, the initiative was there, but it did not help us much, okay? So whenever you have such interaction with Kraken, make it a point that if you want certain development to happen in terms of automation in software, you be very specific, this is what I want, and from them expect a timeline for development.
So one more thing I want to add it regarding the Kraken only. Now they have implemented MS Team for taking the online sessions. Mm. So they were asking like if they want any one more session, means they can provide this training for the faculties. So if our faculty is interested, means I can schedule one session for you people. Because next semester onwards going further, we have to implement the MS Team. We have to connect the classes on MS Team platform. So if you people require one more session to be conducted, means you let us know so that I can inform the Kraken team to have an orientation training on that.
Okay, that's the consensus. Dhananjay, you want a MS Team training? Who is there? Yeah.
No, sir. I already attended the session.
Okay. You have any further queries on the structuring of syllabus and all that?
Structuring of the syllabus, now I know whom to approach, sir. I'll do that.
Okay. So I heard that you had certain problems with this thing. Okay. So if you have, you can, feel free, call me. Okay.
Definitely.
And come with a viable solution. Okay.
Yes.
And also you have to keep in consideration the bottom feeder to the top notch person. Okay. We cannot be,
yes.
I cannot port a New York university syllabus here and say, okay, I have done a great job. Okay. So it looks very impressive on the paper, but practically it will be infrastructure. Okay, so be close to the reality, what is possible, what is not possible. In the last few months, you would have seen what is the possibilities here. If you have a solution, then pick up the syllabus and say, this is what my solution is. Can we improve upon this? Are we clear? Okay.
Okay.
Anyone else? Hey, what happened to the this guy? Pranjal. Where is Pranjal in this whole scheme of things?
He was here.
Where was he? He's missing in action.
Pranjal, sir, I think he's left. Just a minute, sir.
It's okay. Fine. Just I was looking at the new recruits. That's where I didn't find Pranjal. Maybe, yeah, last 1 hour, 2 hours, I didn't see him. Okay. Mr. Shamshul, what is your take? How to go forward? Yeah.
Sir, first of all, I would like to say that I need some kind of training related to teams, which you was talking about.
Okay. What else you require in terms of further honing your skills?
I am just upgrading myself with Unity and all. Okay. And for that, I am getting guidance from the Prabhakar sir also.
Monday onwards we start the training. Please be very careful with the students. These feedbacks are taken very seriously. Okay. Be very professional. You can let your guard down when we are among your peer group, but be very careful in front of the students. Okay. Don't boast about yourself. Don't take the negativity whatever is happening in the work environment there. Okay, with the students. Okay.
Sure, sir.
Because somebody writes something and it will be a trouble for everyone.
Okay.
Are you clear? So some student is disgruntled, he will write, sir, he was talking about his personal experience in life. Why should I be bothered about his personal experience? So these are the kind of complaints we get. Okay. So be very careful when you are handling students. Don't use any foul words. Don't get angry with them. It is their fate. Okay. So handle with utmost equanimity when it comes to students. Okay. Customer-centric exercise now, like a project-centric terms of teaching, it has become customer-centric. If a customer is unhappy, then he can raise all sort of issues.
Obviously.
Okay. Yeah. So be careful when you are around the students. Okay. Whatever your problems you have, you keep it separately and don't involve student in your personal space in whatsoever way. Okay. And be especially careful with the girl students. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because you have not come face to face, because I have hired many people from the industry. So periodically we face issues because they are not sensitized to the mixed environment. Okay. They might go too close to the girl students or whatsoever. Okay. And it results on average one or two firings happens in every year just because of this. Okay. So be very careful with your girl students and also with your peer group. Okay, treat everyone with respect and be okay.
Thank you.
Sir, shall we conclude, sir? Any other queries? Sir, are you there? I think network issue.
Network issue, I think so.
Ma'am, shall we conclude, ma'am, or we wait for sir, ma'am?
No, you can conclude, no, sir. We'll inform.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. It's like, you know, it's a long and wonderful session. We had a nice discussion with sir. I will share the feedback in our just a minute.
WhatsApp group.
Sir. Sir, he asked us to close the session since he is having the power discussions. Okay, thank you all. Thank you so much.